theirs, and I'm really growing to like it.
What is your drink of choice during the lockdown?
My drink of choice, I'm definitely a scotch guy. A nice Dewar's really does it for me.
What about a non-alcoholic drink?
Coffee.
What one TV show would you recommend to people who are quarantining right now?
One show? Star Trek The Next Generation. You can't go wrong. It's got everything you want. It's got high concept science fiction. It's got humanity. It's got great characters. It's the last truly great television show.
What is the biggest pet peeve about being at home?
I can see all the dirt that I don't clean, and it mocks me.
What is the biggest silver lining of staying at home?
I'd say wearing sweatpants, but I do that most of the time anyway. I'll say wearing my Spider-Man costume and not being judged.
What's one book you're loving right now?
I'm a big comic book guy, so I'm reading a lot of comic books. Right now, I'm going back over the classic Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, Amazing Spider-Man run, about the first 40 issues.
We all shop online, and now you could do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
At no time before have voters faced a clearer choice between two parties, two visions, two philosophies, or two agendas.
Let's choose. Choose wisely.
This election will decide whether we save the American dream or whether we allow a socialist agenda to demolish our cherished destiny.
For one chance, just one chance, and tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
And you talked about the national mask mandate. It sounds like that would be one of the first orders of business.
Yes.
How would you enforce that?
It's really it's a standard. I mean, nobody's going to be punished. Come on.
Then as of this moment, they're on double secret probation.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
As I slept, looters were ransacking the shop.
Peacefully protesting in the streets.
They shot and killed David in cold blood.
Protests have been mostly peaceful there.
And then live streamed his execution and his last moments on Earth.
Peaceful protesters.
David's grandson was watching the video on Facebook in real time, not realizing he was watching his own grandfather dying on the sidewalk.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Washington has not changed Donald Trump. Donald Trump has changed Washington.
Always remember, they are coming after me because I am fighting for you. That's what's happening.
Trump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. The president will soon be flying here to New England. He's going to have a speech tonight in southern New Hampshire. I think it's in Londonderry now. It's been the location has been switched around a couple of times, but we'll be talking to Corey Lewandowski at 3:30 and finding out more about it. And there's a lot to get to today. We got a lot of sound from last night. It was a much superior Republican convention to the Democrat convention. I think everybody would agree with that. That was that speech by Ann Doran, the widow of the slain police captain, David Doran in St. Louis. That was heartrending. And then she was there. She was invited to the White House. She took part in the, she was part of the audience in the, South Lawn when the president spoke, and oh man, their heads were exploding. They were going crazy about everything. The Trump 2020 fireworks drove them crazy. The opera singer drove them crazy. Oh, God, there's just so much to get to here today, but I want to start off with Rand Paul. In case you didn't hear, there was a mob outside the White House. They were ringing, they were banging drums and ringing cowbells and doing all kinds of crazy stuff. These were Joe Biden voters, and they then began attacking people as they were coming out, as they were leaving. There were over probably hundreds, if not over maybe over 1,000 people at the at the acceptance speech of the president. And so as they were leaving, they were attacked, even though some of them were members of Congress or state legislature. One of them was Vernon Jones, the state rep from Georgia that we've had on a couple of times. He's a Democrat. And they were calling, he's black, they were calling him the N-word. There were some gay people there that had taken part and done some videos for President Trump that were used in the convention. They called them the F-word, gay people. And then they went after Rand Paul as well, Senator Rand Paul. Now think about that, Senator Rand Paul, a couple of years ago, he was attacked by a deranged Democrat, a Bernie bro, Hodgson. He was at that baseball practice, the Republican baseball practice, where Steve Scalise was shot and almost killed, the minority whip from Louisiana, the congressman. And Rand Paul had to run for cover then. I think he ran into the dugout as bullets were flying. So then a few months later, he's cutting his lawn in, I think, Covington, Kentucky, and he's attacked by a nut physician, a fellow physician, from New Bedford, originally from New Bedford. And he's almost killed. I think his lung was collapsed. He had some ribs were broken. He was in excruciating pain for a long, long time. And then the federal judge refused to send the deranged moonbat to prison. I think the Justice Department appealed it, and he may have ended up in prison and had to pay Rand Paul a couple hundred thousand. But so Rand Paul has almost been killed twice. And last night he's leaving the White House, and he's attacked again. He's menaced. He's with his wife and two other women, and they are menaced by a mob of deranged Joe Biden supporters. Cut 18. Here we go.
We had looked out, you know, we came out of the speech
at the White House.
We looked into the street. Our hotel was only right across the street from the White House, but we couldn't go because the mob was already chasing people down that chose to go out that exit. So the Secret Service says, get on a bus and ride to the Trump Hotel. So we got on a bus. It took 45 minutes to get through all the mobs. We get there safely, and then we say we'll get an Uber to go all the way back where we came from, and we wanted to be dropped off at the hotel. But as we got close to it, the streets were blocked and no one would let us through. And what happened is there was two blocks, and I regret that I made this decision, but I said we're going to walk the two blocks. We walked one block, but as we walked one block, we could see some police in the distance, but we also saw a mob of about 30 people marching and yelling. They all of a sudden saw me right as we got to the policeman, fortunately, or I don't think we'd have survived.
I don't think we would have survived. Imagine that. The guy's a U.S. senator, and he's being attacked outside the White House by a mob of Democrats. What is this, Fort Sumter again?
The craziest part is that the mob kept yelling, say her name, Breonna
right.
Taylor, who is one of the one of the
victims.
People,
she was killed in Louisville.
The,
there
right,
was a, there was
the
a no-knock raid on her. They were looking for her boyfriend, who was a drug dealer, and he was arrested
right. and
yesterday.
She was killed,
by the
and
way.
It was horrible. And the craziest part is that Senator and Dr. Rand Paul actually brought forward legislation, justice for
right.
Breonna Taylor. He's been
right.
outspoken, a supporter of the movement
he
for her.
He filed the legislation. He wrote the legislation to ban no-knock raids.
And
although they did knock, but they called it a no-knock raid. But the reason the cops busted the door down was nobody answered the door, and she was inside. It's unfortunate that she's dead. It's wrong. But, you know, the thing is, he is the one who's trying to get some kind of prevention from this ever happening again.
Right. And it speaks to what David Dorn's widow was talking about last night, which is these violent protests and these mobs don't make any sense. They're saying Black Lives Matter and they're killing a black police officer, a retired black police officer. They're saying Black Lives Matter and they're coming after a man who tried to pass, you know, reform for one of the victims of these terrible killings. And it's just, it doesn't make any sense. There's no logic to it anymore.
I know. And then, as I told you, Vernon Jones, the state rep from Georgia, was screamed at by white people calling him the N-word last night when he was leaving the White House. And then this afternoon, there's some minister, I never heard of him, Jamal Bryant. And listen to what he has to say about the black people who were on the South Lawn last night. So that would include Vernon Jones. That would include Mrs. Dorn and her kids. That would include a whole bunch of people. I think it would include Herschel Walker too. Here's what this minister who's at the big Washington March today. This is what he had to say about all the black people who were at the speech last night. Cut 17.
Harriet Tubman, who said, "I freed thousands of slaves, but I would have freed hundreds more had they known they were slaves. I only thought about that when I saw the slaves on TV this week endorsing Donald Trump. I said, if only they knew they were slaves, they could have been rendered free."
How is that any different from what Joe Biden said? There's no diversity of opinion in the black community. If you're not voting for Joe Biden, you ain't black. That's a black guy saying that. He's saying anyone who's for Donald Trump is a slave. All right. 844-500-4242. Let's have another description of the black people who are for Donald Trump here. This is from Joy Reid, the woman who has put homophobic slurs out on her Twitter feed, but she claims that she was hacked by time travelers who went back to 2010 or thereabouts and put in these homophobic slurs. She also has been known not to pay her income taxes, but now she's down on other black people. Cut 35.
He used those people as props.
Props.
He used people.
Are they slaves
that
or props?
Would be from the S-hole countries he would not let into this country. People who look like those people, who have the religions perhaps of those people, people that are brown like those people, are barred from getting into the United States. They're not allowed to come in because they're not from Norway. But Donald Trump used a color collection, a sort of crayon box of colors tonight, to try to paint a false image of himself as welcoming to immigrants and welcoming to black people and brown people. It was offensive to see that done in the People's House. That the naturalization ceremony is a sacred thing to a new American. It is not about Donald Trump, and he made it about Donald Trump, and he used the People's House to sort of, you know, play politics with.
You know
that's
what
not
they
a
teach?
Dreamhouse.
You know what they teach
that's
immigrants? You have to obey the laws of the land. One of the laws of the land is you will render unto Caesar what is Caesar's. In other words, paying taxes. Joy Reid didn't get that memo. A lot of people don't get that memo. And
Joy Reid would be this harsh with the time-traveling hacker who wrote all those, you know, homophobic, xenophobic things on her old blog.
Right. What does Joy Reid think of all the homophobic slurs that were hurled at the gay people leaving the White House last night? Could they have been some of those time travelers? They've become unstuck in time, like Joe Biden. 844-500-4242. 561 points out. Didn't Donald Trump marry an immigrant? He married an illegal alien. Don't you read Bette Midler's tweets? Come on. I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr. You can trust him. He's not like the others.
Campers, are you thinking about getting a new or used RV this year? This is Howie Carr, and Cold Springs RV is ready for you. The 2021 models are now arriving daily, but they won't last long. After one visit, you will understand why they are a one-stop shop for all things camping. With all the top RV brands, a new state-of-the-art service center, a new RV body shop, and a huge store full of accessories, you don't need to go anywhere else. If it is service you need, the brand-new state-of-the-art service facility is ready for you. They service all makes and brands. If your RV needs body work, they have you covered. They can help you with collision repair, roof replacement, or even a new paint job. From minor repairs to major insurance jobs, Cold Springs RV can do it all. As a full-service RV dealer, you know they can fix just about anything. If you are a service technician and want to work for the best, ask about employment today. Cold Springs RV, Route 114 in Ware, New Hampshire. ColdSpringsRV.com, your destination for all things camping.
Joe Biden accuses Trump of being a racist, but if you listen to Biden's comments, you would agree that he doth protest too much.
If you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not, what do you think, huh? Are you a junkie?
The first mainstream African American who is articulate and bright and clean.
Madam President, we have predators on our streets.
That kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate. And not a gangbanger.
They are beyond the pale, many of those people.
God love you, you've been here all day. My Lord, you may feel like you're being incarcerated.
We have no choice but to take them out of society.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
I think the two-party system is good for the South and good for the Negro.
They're gonna put you all back in chains.
Unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community. With incredibly different attitudes about different things.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If Mr. Gunnar was a person, what college would she attend?
The U.S. Coast Guard Academy.
Is Mr. Gunnar a conservative or a Democrat?
Mr. Gunnar is a fiscal conservative and a social liberal.
If you could have dinner with any president, dead or alive, who would it be?
Calvin Coolidge. He was from Massachusetts, and I liked his attitude towards public sector unions. And he said, the business of America is business. He's my guy.
Other than yourself, which columnist do you respect the most?
The late George Frazier. He was a columnist for the Boston Herald, the Boston Globe. Most people have forgotten him now. Jimmy Cannon was pretty good. He was so good that Mike Barnicle used to steal stuff from him all the time. Breslin was good in his early days, not so good later on, but when he was working for the Herald Tribune, back when I was a kid in New York, he was damn good.
This is Kevin from Brockton.
This is Karen from Boiling Springs, South Carolina.
This is Officer Mark calling from beautiful Stratford County, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
This is tax-free weekend in Massachusetts. No thanks to Governor Parker. This is a state law. He had to order tax-free, sales tax-free. So we've got a special deal. We got a new T-shirt out just for the end of the Republican convention. Socialism sucks. If you order a Socialism Sucks T-shirt from the HowieCarrShow.com store, you will also get a free copy, autographed copy of What Really Happened, How Donald J. Trump Saved America from Hillary Clinton. That's in 2016, obviously. So you get a T-shirt and you get the autographed book and no sales tax on it. And if you go to HowieCarrShow.com to do some shopping at the store, and we still have those Apex Entertainment gift certificates too. Those are good deals for the week leading up to Labor Day. You're not going to be able to do anything else on the on the last week of this summer. So you might as well go to Apex Entertainment. You can have a lot of fun there, and you can have a meals, get a $50 gift certificate for $25. But when you go to HowieCarrShow.com, and before you click on the store, you can check out my column on the my thoughts on the Republican convention. 844-500-4242. So check out my columns and check out the Socialism Sucks t-shirt, and it's a good buy. We throw in the autographed copy of the book, and there's no sales tax. HowieCarrShow.com. Click on store. Today's poll question is sponsored by our friends at MassFiscal.org. MassFiscal has led the charge against tax increases, most recently opposing the horrible TCI gas tax. Sign up for free at MassFiscal.org now. I've been wanting to do this column for this poll question for a long time. Today seemed like a good day for it. Jared, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
What do you think Charlie Parker will do?
Should he? You got to reword that a little bit,
all right,
Jared.
What do you think?
Should Charlie Parker become a Republican? Should he become? No, he's not going to become.
That's not going to happen.
That's impossible. That can't happen. That's like living forever or finding a unicorn. Should Charlie Parker remain a Republican or should he become a Democrat? I'm going to say he should become a Democrat.
47% of the audience says just become a Democrat.
Let's reword that, okay? Just become a Democrat. I'm surprised 53% want him to remain a Republican. All right. Another nasty thing that was said about the black people at the acceptance speech last night. One of them was Alice Marie Johnson. She's the woman who was pardoned today by the president. And Kim Kardashian spoke up for her, and her sentence was commuted today. She was actually pardoned. And there was a tweet from Politico calling all the blacks props again. That it's not just it's a Democrat talking point. That's why Joy Reid said it at MSNBC. That's why Politico used the exact same word, prop. So she said on Fox and Friends, I am not a prop and I'm not a puppet. I make my own choices as to what I'd like to do. 844-500-4242. Tim, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Tim.
Hi, Howie. I wanted to speak with you about your guest yesterday, Mr. Tom Fenton.
Yes.
He actually ruined my afternoon. I thought he was all gloom and doom. We have this Obamagate situation and Bill Barr. They have Kleinsmith. I mean, they're not going to have any prosecutions.
I'm sorry he ruined your afternoon. He didn't make me feel any better either, but he's trying to be a realist about everything. If you're looking for a ray of sunshine, there are stories today that Senator Lindsey Graham, who, you know, we all take with some skepticism, given his record of saying a lot and not delivering so much. He has apparently been interviewing the FBI agent Joe Pientka, who was Peter Strzok's running mate when they were interviewing Michael Flynn. And Lindsey Graham has been trying to keep it under wraps, all these interviews. So I don't blame you for being depressed after listening to Tom Fenton, but I don't shoot the messenger. Don't shoot the messenger. He's dealing with reality. I'm Howie Carr.
I'm Kevin O'Connor. I'm a candidate for United States Senate. I'm a lawyer, a husband, I'm a father of four boys, and I'm a small business owner. Why am I running? I'm tired of the BS coming our way from Washington. We need to stop the Democratic Socialist agenda. When I'm your senator, I'll make sure that happens. On September 1st, vote for me for U.S. Senate. I'm Kevin O'Connor, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Kevin O'Connor for U.S. Senate.
The stressful summer of 2020 is winding down, but now is the perfect time to take off for some fun in beautiful Nantucket. Southern Airways fast flights from Norwood, Providence, Hyannis, and now New Bedford will get you to Nantucket without traffic jams, crowded ferry rides, or the need to quarantine. I fly Southern, and let me tell you, it is a first-class and hassle-free way to fly. So take off to Nantucket from friendly Norwood, Providence, Hyannis, or New Bedford airports. Book today at iFlySouthern.com or call 800-329-0485.
Biden might be the frontrunner for the Democrats, but that isn't stopping him from serving up a whole lot of gaffes. Take a listen.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat to America for three reasons. One, he is a genuine threat to our...
I had permission to hug Lonnie.
You know, he says, let's make America great again. Let's make America America again.
I think I'm either low IQ or slow, or I don't know what I am. You know, slow Joe Biden.
The thanks for the Mary and that I'm going to be here a lot.
I want the press to know she pulled me close. I just want you to know, okay?
President Trump inherited an economy from Obama Biden.
By the way, he gave me permission to touch him.
They can't even figure out how to deal with the fact that they have this great division between the China Sea and the mountains in the east, I mean in the west.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a two-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Out of all of your books, which is your favorite title and why?
I think my favorite title is Hitman because it's very effective. I thought long and hard about it. We're going to make it Boston Hitman, but then why make it Boston Hitman? Just make it Hitman. Make it a universal subject.
If you could have dinner with one author, dead or alive, who would it be?
I would probably have dinner with William Shakespeare. I know that's a cliche response, but he was the greatest writer in the English language, no question about it.
If you won Mega Millions, would you retire completely?
I used to say no, I would not retire, but yeah, I think I would retire now.
If you had to leave all of your money to one charity, which would it be?
The Salvation Army. I like what the Salvation Army does. I don't think they have too many highly paid executives trying to be social justice warriors.
Here's 1 minute of President Eric Swalwell.
Chris, so far the evidence is uncontradicted that the president used taxpayer dollars to ask the Ukrainians to help him cheat an election.
But I will always be real with you. I will be bold without the bold. Welcome to my fellow candidates, whom I consider we are all a part of being the Avengers. The Republicans in 2016, that was the Hunger Games.
And, you know, it's said often that history doesn't repeat itself, it rhymes. And we heard a lot of rhymes yesterday.
My wife, Brittany, also wants you to know we've got two beautiful children, Nelson and Cricket. But the decision to have children was her choice.
I'm the only candidate calling for a ban and buyback on every single assault weapon.
Again, we have to have an ankle monitor on this president. This is the worst possible time for a serial offender like him to be running around unsupervised.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. As you know, the President of the United States is soon will be airborne in Air Force One on his way to the Granite State, live free or die state of New Hampshire. He's going to be holding a rally at 6 o'clock tonight at the Manchester Airport. Joining us now is his former campaign manager and a New Hampshire resident, and he's going to be on Air Force One in a few minutes, Corey Lewandowski. Corey, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Well, Howie, thanks for having me. It's a big day for us again.
Yeah, it is. This is the first step after formally accepting the nomination. The president is coming back right here to New England to campaign in your home state. What's he going to be talking about tonight?
You know, Howie, he's going to remind the American people a little bit what he did last night, which was talk about the successes that he's had over the first 4 years in the job, talk about what his vision is for the next 4 years in the job if he's given the opportunity to serve. But we're going to continue to juxtapose this against Joe Biden's record of almost 5 decades in office. And the great news is, you know, Joe Biden made a huge announcement today. How would you see it? He said, 10 days from now, I'm coming out of the basement. I'm going to start campaigning in 10 days from now. I mean, that's truly what the big announcement today was, that after Labor Day, Joe's going to start the campaign.
How about Kamala Harris? She had a big announcement too, Corey. She was asked by NBC, the Today Show. I mean, it couldn't get a friendlier confines to be asked questions. And they said, what's with this national mask mandate? And she said, oh, come on. We're not really serious. There aren't going to be any penalties. Nobody likes to wear masks. I thought this was a big part of their platform, Corey. The national mask mandate. Now we're saying, never mind.
The only time Joe is wearing a mask is when he's near Kamala. The crazy thing was, he's had such a good couple of weeks, Joe has, right? He Zoomed for the first time. He figured out how to use the iPhone, even though it was upside down. The big question he kept asking was, how did they get Kamala in this little device in front of me? Is this a movie? They thought it was Honey, I Shrunk the Kids again. Said, no, Joe, she's not really inside that. It's just a telephone. He goes, oh, wow, that's amazing technology these days.
And yesterday, yesterday he confused the guy who was shot in Kenosha with the 17-year-old from Illinois who shot the two Antifa people. He got him confused.
Howie, the guy got confused because he was out of his basement on the first floor, and while he was on the first floor, what happened? The dog came running by. Did you see that, Howie? Literally, he's on the first floor, and all of a sudden, you know, he's got a different backdrop. The fireplace back there looks beautiful, and the dog goes running by in the background. I go, we're going to turn the keys over to the most powerful nation in the history of the planet to a guy who can't even control his friggin' dog? Are you shitting me, Howie?
Okay. Hey, kid,
Are you kidding me, Howie?
I had to motion to Jarrett to cut that. Watch out there, Corey. Watch out. All right, we cut it.
I get so fired up because the media gives him a pass every time. Every time.
I got to ask you, before we get to some unserious stuff, I got to ask you about what happened with Rand Paul last night being attacked again for a third time. Vernon Jones, the state rep from Georgia, a black guy, is called the N-word by white Joe Biden supporters outside the White House. Gay supporters of Trump that were at the acceptance speech, they're called the F-word. What the hell's going on, Corey?
Chris Ager, who's the national committeeman from New Hampshire, he and his wife were walking, and you can see the video. There's a woman screaming in his face for literally almost 3 minutes straight, I'm going to effing, blank you, consistently. And he just kept on walking, all because he came over to the White House, had the privilege to see the president give an acceptance speech. That's the hatred on the left. It's complete hatred. And I don't understand how anybody in America thinks that that helps, how anybody in America wants that in their community. And to Chris's credit, to Rand Paul's credit, to Vernon's credit, you know what? They just kept on going. But look, that's a very serious situation. When you're in the nation's capital and you can't walk down the street without fear of being attacked or physically assaulted, we have something wrong with our country, and the American people aren't going to stand for it. And that's why last night in his acceptance speech, President Trump recognized the men and women of the CBP and those who stand on the thin blue line. And we're going to continue to talk about this, Howie.
In New Hampshire, you were thinking about running for that Senate seat. You're not, obviously. But Jean Shaheen, I see her ads on TV all the time. Sometimes I get confused, and I think she's a Republican. It seems like she's only being endorsed by Republicans and only talking about how she's gone up against her own party. Have you noticed that, Corey? If the Democrats are so confident about winning this election, why are their own candidates running away from the national party?
Jean Shaheen is a chameleon, okay? She comes to Washington, D.C., Howie. She votes in lockstep with Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer every step of the way. She voted against Neil Gorsuch. She voted against Justice Kavanaugh. She's voted against a number of our cabinet officials, right? Has always done that. Then she goes back home and pretends to be this sweet, innocent woman who works on a bipartisan basis. It's just not true. It's the same game that Ivanka Trump talked about in her speech last night, where she said politicians want to continue the blame game as opposed to solving the problem so they can go back and keep talking about it back home. It's exactly what Jean Shaheen is doing. It's time to retire, Jean. She's had a good run in public service. It's time for her to either fess up and say that AOC and Rashid Tlaib are her party. That's her party now. And she has to endorse them or get out and run as a Republican.
Don't forget it, Ayanna Pressley here in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, who says we need more unrest. More unrest.
Yeah, another real beauty, Howie. A real beauty, we like to say.
Yeah. So speaking of Ivanka's speech, as you know, I thought it was a nice speech that she made. She kind of tried to humanize the president, and it was very pleasant. And like most people who were speaking, she seemed to be a very agreeable person, as she always is. But she mentioned her son, Joseph, you know, 3 years old, and how he had built a Lego White House for the president of the United States. And Corey, as you know, the mainstream media, who refuse to write anything about Hunter Biden, the whoremongering, alcoholic, crack pipe leaving in a rented car, seducing his sister-in-law, knocking up a waitress, a stripper in D.C., they refuse to talk about Hunter Biden and his $83,000 a month from Burisma, but they suddenly decided to fact check whether or not there was really a Lego White House. What do you make of that?
You know, Howie, I thought Ivanka did an amazing job last night. Not an easy thing to do in front of 25 million people giving a live speech. And she did a really good job. And that little boy, if you notice later when his grandfather, the president of the United States, was speaking, was sitting on his father's lap, Jared Kushner's lap there on the stage. I don't know if you could see it, but he was right in front of me. And, you know, this notion that there are two separate sets of rules, one if you're a conservative Trump supporter and one if you're a thief, a crook. Hey, it was only one crack pipe you left behind that we know of. The rental car company said there was only one in there, right? And I guess, you know, Ivanka's son only built one White House, so I guess it's an even comparison, except they're not, I mean, come on, Howie. The media has lost all of their credibility. They honestly have. They've lost it all.
I know. And then they realized.
Just said, we're tired of it.
They realized there was a picture of the Lego White House and, you know, in the Oval Office. So then they decided to follow up because they're crack reporters, Corey. They decided to make here's one, this woman, a reporter named Andrea Bernstein. I've asked the White House if 3-year-old Joseph did indeed build it of his own initiative or if he had assistance. Dun, 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 dun.
Oh my God. Howie, don't forget, these are the same people who wrote that Donald Trump removed the bust of Martin Luther King Jr. from the Oval Office on his first day in office, which, of course, what they forgot to tell everyone afterwards was that the bust was in the exact same spot. It was just hidden behind a Secret Service agent who was there. You know, these are the same people who have lied continuously about this president and their family. And, hey, maybe the 3-year-old had some assistance, or maybe the media collectively couldn't put one of these things together. They are kind of tricky, you know, these Lego sets.
So is the president going to be a little looser tonight? I mean, he was, I understand why he was, a little bit more serious last night. That it was a more formal occasion. Is he going to be a little looser tonight at the rally?
You know, I think you're going to see more of a, what I like to call vintage Donald Trump tonight, right? Somebody who is going to be on and off the teleprompter. I mean, he was on teleprompter almost all of last night, except I think just one sentence where he said, talking about the spying on the campaign and spying on the White House. That wasn't in the prepared remarks, but of course we had to talk about it. Other than that, he was right on script. I think tonight's going to be a little different, to be honest with you, and I think the crowd wants to see it different.
Absolutely.
He's great when he's on teleprompter, but he's better when he's not.
Yeah, we want to see a little looser, the routine You know, just like you go to a rock concert, you want to hear all the greatest hits. And that's what we, let me play something for you. I don't know if you heard the fact checker last night. This guy's name is Daniel Dale. I mean, this is crazy. I just want to get your response to this. This is Anderson Cooper's fact checker on the speech last night. Cut 11.
Anderson, this president is a serial liar, and he serially lied tonight. I counted preliminarily more than 20 false or misleading claims. I want to go through a whole bunch of them quickly because I think it's all important. Trump said Joe Biden is, quote, talking about taking down the border wall. Biden has specifically, explicitly rejected that idea. He just said he'll stop further additional construction. Trump claimed, as always, that he is the one who passed the Veterans Choice Law. Barack Obama signed that into law in 2014. Trump signed a 2018 law to modify it. Trump said, I have done more for the African-American community than any president since Abraham Lincoln. That is ludicrous. Lyndon Johnson, for one, signed the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act. Trump again touted a, quote, record 9 million job gain over the past 3 months. He didn't mention, as usual, that that gain follows a record 22 million job loss over the previous 2 months.
And then he said China, he said China wants Biden. And he said, well, China wants Biden only because they don't think Trump is a stable candidate. I mean, is this crazy or what, Corey?
Howie, people stop watching this stuff. They do because they can see it through their own eyes, and they've seen it now for almost 4 years. They've seen that their families are better off because of Donald Trump. They see that their economic policies that they have to deal with, meaning their checkbooks, are better off because of Donald Trump. They see that Donald Trump gave the men and women in uniform pay raises, and they know that Donald Trump stands with the men and women who serve on the thin blue line that protect us every day. And the converse of that is very clear. The Democrats want to defund the police. You can reword it any way you want. They want to defund the police. They want to take money from one department and reallocate it to something else. They want to completely allow lawlessness in these streets. And what they have said is, hey, you know what? We can't control what the mayors do, but they're not out stopping this, Howie. Joe Biden's response to the coronavirus, by contrast to the president, was, I'll let some unelected bureaucrat scientist who none of you have ever known determine if we're going to keep our country open. I'll listen to them. That's what losers do. What leaders do is they make decisions. Trump listens to everybody and then does what he thinks is best. Joe Biden has very candidly said, hey, some unelected bureaucrat can go do this. And my guess is Joe will never know who that person is. They'll just tell him what to do, which is going to be the case for the rest of this campaign.
And there's going to be a national mask mandate until some friendly interviewer on a network asks you about it. And then you say, we weren't really serious about that. Do you think they're going to be debates?
This whole thing goes away, Howie, this whole thing goes away on November 4th, okay, after the election. The coronavirus was never really that serious if Joe Biden wins, okay? All of the world's ills that Donald Trump has created in the last 3.5 years, which, of course, he had nothing to do with over the last 50 years, all go away, and everything's right in the world if you listen to the media.
Do you think they're going to be debates, Corey?
We are going to ask again to have the Presidential Debate Commission moved the debates up. The president, as you may have seen, has asked to disclose all of the medications that Joe Biden is on prior to debating.
I was going to ask you if he was he serious? Some people say he wasn't really serious.
100%, Howie. No, he's 100% serious.
I think it should be. I think he should say there should be a urinalysis test, maybe even have hair sample tests.
Look, I want to know if Jill can pull that little string in the back of Joe's mouth from the other side of the podium. I'm not sure how that works. I mean, she's got a really good ventriloquist job going on here. But the truth is, right, we have a right to know, and the American people have a right to know, what drugs Joe Biden is on, if any. Because when Donald Trump takes his annual physical, he has to disclose them all. He has to disclose everything he's on, including whether it's Lipitor or whatever it is.
Right.
It all gets disclosed. Joe Biden doesn't have to disclose anything. He doesn't have the mental acuity to be the leader of the free world. We know that, and I believe, and other people have said this, that he is on some type of drug that allows him to have some level of sanity, like when he delivered the speech for the Democratic nomination. He passed the bar, Howie. He showed up on stage. He passed the bar, and if you listen to guys, you know, they said, oh, my God, it was the most beautiful night ever. Joe actually made it. Like, it was a shock he was going to make it through the whole thing.
Yeah.
We should know what this guy's really on.
Corey, you have to take a drug test to get a CDL, a commercial driver's license, right? Why should to become president of the United States?
Howie, you have to pass a background check and I think take a drug test to be an Uber driver. Okay, it's just amazing. Right? I'm just telling you.
All right.
The state of Massachusetts, you have to pass a two-part background check, and I think a drug test is part of it, to drive Uber at the airport. And we're going to let Sleepy Joe get away with this?
All right, Corey, we appreciate you being with us. Give our best to the president. Tell him we'd love to hear from him today. You have the number. We'd love to hear from him. But, Corey, we'll be talking to you again soon. Have a good time tonight at the rally. Thanks.
Thank you.
Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Usually we just brush it off or blame ourselves, saying things like, I lost my mojo. Or we avoid it altogether with excuses like, I had a long day at work. Or, sorry, honey, I'm just not feeling it. But with Roman, it is easy to talk about it. With a healthcare professional who can prescribe real medication, it's simple, safe, and totally discreet. With Roman, you can get a free online evaluation and ongoing care for erectile dysfunction, all from the comfort and privacy of your own home. A healthcare professional will work with you to find the best treatment plan. If medication is appropriate, Roman will ship it to you with free 2-day shipping. No awkward visits to the pharmacy having to put on a mask. No awkward visits to a healthcare professional's office. It's still difficult to make appointments. You know that. You can do everything from the comfort and privacy of your own home. The whole process is straightforward, simple, and discreet. Getting started is simple. Just go to GetRoman.com/Howie and complete an online visit. Erectile dysfunction used to be tough to tackle, but now there's Roman. Complete an online visit today to connect with a healthcare professional and take care of it. Go to GetRoman.com/Howie today. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment. That's GetRoman.com/Howie. GetRoman.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
He didn't come here to be made sport of. Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Precinct 10 Restaurant in Weymouth. From their creamy baked mac and cheese with short ribs to their Louisiana-style paella, Precinct 10 is first class. Open at 4, Tuesday through Sunday for dine-in and curbside takeout.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be. I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year because I've destroyed her political career and now I won't get a chance to run against her and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer. Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
This is Deb in Danielson, Connecticut.
This is Greg in Boston, Mass.
This is Elizabeth in Wakefield, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Okay, let's get this poll question straight. Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment. GetRoman.com/Howie. GetRoman.com/Howie. Okay. How is it worded now?
All right. Should Charlie Parker become a Democrat or remain a Republican?
He should become a Democrat.
Just become a Democrat is in at 64%, 36%
that's
say
more like
remain
it.
A Republican.
That's more like it. I think it's going to go up from there, too. Uber Jason says, it's actually harder to be an Uber driver than it is to be an elementary school bus driver in terms of a background check. No drug test, but he's right. But Corey's right about the two-part background check. And here's a guy, 774. I had to pass a drug test to deliver prepared food for a local grocery store. Yeah, I would love to see. I hope the president brings that up tonight. And if he should call in today, I don't know if he will or not, but we'll see. If he calls in, I'm going to ask him directly. Because again, they're trying to dismiss it as a joke, but sometimes he says stuff. You know, there is truth in good humor. You know, the best humor has to have an element of reality and truth to it. And I think it would be good to have Joe taking a drug test so we could see. I mean, if you want to drug test your food delivery guys, shouldn't you drug test the future president of the United States? I'm Howie Carr.
Matthews Brothers with 1T, America's oldest window manufacturer. For over 8 years, we here at Matthews Brothers have ended every stupid commercial with that simple but repetitive spelling reminder. Even so, people come up to us every day and say, "Hey there, Mr. Man, were those Matthews Brothers fictional or were they real, like the Marx Brothers, the Wright Brothers, or the Blues Brothers?" We usually respond with, "Listen here, sister, 25 years before Tom Edison invented electricity, Spencer, Noah, and Sanford Matthews started making their first wicked awesome windows in Belfast, Maine. Being the clever fellas they were, they decided to call the company Matthews Brothers. Over the next 166 years, the company passed from the Matthews to the Frost to the Lang and finally to the Hawthorne family, who today are in their third generation of leadership and management. This continuity has allowed us to maintain the Matthews Brothers traditions of superior quality, outstanding performance, and surprising affordability. You can learn more about our wicked awesome Maine-made windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. That's Matthews Brothers with 1T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer, and I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places. And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time. Oh!
Curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? Oh. That's a goody two-shoes favorite curse word if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, Orchid, by... is that you have to figure out who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class. And my Aunt B has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians did.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be
ask,
much better.
If I may ask one other question. Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the 6 states of New England. During this time, we've proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year, because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles in.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
At no time before have voters faced a clearer choice between two parties, two visions, two philosophies, or two agendas.
Let's choose. Choose wisely.
This election will decide whether we save the American dream or whether we allow a socialist agenda to demolish our cherished destiny.
For one chance, just one chance, and tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
And you talked about the national mask mandate. Yeah. It sounds like that would be one of the first orders of business.
Yes.
How would you enforce that?
It's really a standard. I mean, nobody's going to be punished. Come on.
Then as of this moment, they're on double secret probation.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
As I slept, looters were ransacking the shop.
Peacefully protesting in the streets.
They shot and killed David in cold blood.
Protests have been mostly peaceful there.
And then live streamed his execution and his last moments on Earth.
Peaceful protesters.
David's grandson was watching the video on Facebook in real time, not realizing he was watching his own grandfather dying on the sidewalk.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Washington has not changed Donald Trump. Donald Trump has changed Washington.
Always remember, they are coming after me because I am fighting for you. That's what's happening.
Trump swabs, hacks, and moon bats, beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. The president, the convention is over, and now he is heading to our neck of the woods, New England. He's going to be speaking tonight in a couple of hours at a rally in at Manchester, Londonderry, New Hampshire line, somewhere in there, the Manchester airport. The Air Force One is winging its way north right now. And in a related development, Joe Biden says he's going to come out of the basement after Labor Day. In case you were wondering, if you have unclear, Labor Day is 10 days away.
Nothing says enthusiasm like I'm going to start campaigning in 10 days.
Right. Well, your opponent, who is the incumbent, by the way, is already campaigning.
Oh, he's been campaigning. Here's the thing. Last night, I just have to give credit where credit is due. Last night was so amazing. I had texts coming in from so many people who were watching it. Trump just has this unbelievable energy. Melania looks so beautiful in the green. They had the opera singer singing Ave Maria. They had the fireworks. And I think a really good sign that Howie and I talk about is that the crazier these people go in the media, the more you know you're doing something right. And here's why. Andrea Mitchell, Jake Tapper, Wolf Blitzer, all of these left-wing reporters, they hate fireworks, the song Hallelujah, opera, the White House being used for like such a patriotic event. That drives them crazy. They were losing it this morning. They couldn't believe it. The Hatch Act. They're going to start more probes. The legality of it all. It's these people don't like fun and they don't like America. And it's getting really sad.
Yeah, it is. And they also don't like gay people who are Republicans, like Rick Grenell. They don't like black people who are Republicans, like Vernon Jones, the state rep from Georgia, or Senator Tim Scott from South Carolina. They don't like women who are anti-abortion.
Based off my Twitter feed, they do not like me. I'm letting everyone know that right now.
What? Well, why are you? What? Show everyone your sweater there.
So I'm wearing my American flag sweater because, so in this MAGA news cycle, Howie, and I know you go through the same thing, it's an emotional roller coaster. Some days you come in, as you know, yesterday, I was in a terrible mood. I was so sick of the negativity, the riots, the looting. I was really kind of burnt out from it. And then the next day, you start to see people waking up and realizing everything Trump's doing is for the country. He set up these two visions of America that are really, one is really scary. It's Joe Biden's America. And he set up his vision, and it was just wonderful to see. So I feel great today. I'm feeling good. I loved the RNC, wearing my American flag. And if the president happens to be listening, I want him to know, and I don't say this a lot, if he were to call into the show, I would let him take over Grace's news.
Well, that's good. We hope.
It's very big of me, I know.
I know. We just put in an informal request.
Yes. But it was such a great note. We got to get through some of these clips, though, Howie, because it's crazy the reaction from the press. And you don't have to take my word for it. I want to start with Dana Bash, because she just was so tongue-tied over what she was seeing last night. I don't know if it was the fireworks or what. Let's play cut 12.
It's bizarre to be having this conversation as we're listening to an opera singer saying Ave Maria on the south lawn of the White House. I mean, this is remarkable in every sense of the word.
And I also want to play, this is Wolf Blitzer. He's talking about how he couldn't, what Trump is doing and these two visions. Now I'm having trouble finding it on my sheet because there's so many. Well, let's go to Jake Tapper. Jake Tapper had a hard time believing everything. This is cut 28.
Yeah, I agree. Can we just take 1 minute to acknowledge how untraditional, to use one word for it, the scene that we're witnessing right now is the president has just accepted the nomination of his party from the White House, which has never been done before. And now we're not hearing Happy Days Are Here Again. We're hearing an opera singer sing Hallelujah.
Oh, it's so, it makes my skin crawl.
This is Jake Tapper. Must I say it again? Give his curriculum vitae. He used to be the flack for the congresswoman from suburban Philadelphia, who is now the mother-in-law of Chelsea Clinton. And his boss's husband, who was a congressman from Iowa, went to prison for bank fraud and still owes $10 million in restitution. This is his journalistic credentials. He was a made member of the Clinton crime family. He spent 4 hours on CNN back in January 2017 promoting the dodgy dossier, which we now know was paid for by his boss.
Very fake.
Oh, speaking of Jake Tapper, Howie, I found the cut I originally wanted to play. This is Wolf Blitzer. And once again, they state these things that Trump is saying as if they're fact-checking it, when everything fact-checks just fine. This is cut 25.
Jake, he's suggesting that if Biden is elected, this country will turn into a disaster. It will be a socialist, if not a Marxist country. The economy will collapse and everything we know about America will go away.
Right. It's kind of preposterous.
It is?
Depends who you're talking to.
It is
not very preposterous to me.
You should see that. You should see the tweets that the blue check people, the La La Land and Hollywood sent out here. Evil, vile cretin. Someone named Sophia Bush. Who is she? Sophia Bush?
She's an actress. She was on One Tree Hill, I believe.
Here comes the straight up racism with all the lies. Wow, just wow. Then someone named Brown, Yvette Nicole Brown. Who is she?
I think she's a comedian.
A comedian. Well, she says, I'm no longer sane. That thing broke me tonight.
Okay, but here's the thing, too, that people have to remember. I don't want to just play the left-wing nuts reacting to what happened. I want to play some of the people that were speaking last night because really incredible sound. And one quote that stuck out to me was from the president when he said he questioned how the Democrats are going to lead the country. This is cut 33.
So tonight I ask you a simple question. How can the Democrat Party ask to lead our country when it spends so much time tearing down our country?
I thought that was a great line. And another line he said, which I want to talk about once we play it, is because it's something Trump has always said from the beginning, which is they're attacking me because I'm standing up for you. Let's play this, cut 32.
Liberal politicians claim to be concerned about the strength of American institutions. But who exactly is attacking them? Who is hiring the radical professors, judges, and prosecutors? Who is trying to abolish immigration enforcement and establish speech codes designed to muzzle dissent? In every case, the attacks on American institutions are being waged by radical left. Always remember, they are coming after me because I am fighting for you. That's what's happening.
And it sounds, when he says that, it sounds dramatic because we've heard him say it before. But here's the thing. I think the RNC this week really highlighted that because when you saw the depths that they would sink to, these people on these blue check marks, to attack, you know, Kayleigh McEnany for getting a mastectomy. And
they said Nikki Haley had no right to call herself a woman of color.
A woman of color.
Because she wasn't dark enough. And they said, why did she change her name? Nikki is her middle name. And Haley, she took her husband's name when she got married.
And then Alice Marie Johnson, who I think anyone would watch her speech and just be so moved by how amazing she is. She's an exceptional person. Well, they say she's being used as a prop.
How about the guy from North Carolina that stood up in the wheelchair?
In the wheelchair, and they made fun of him.
Yeah, and NPR, some reporter for NPR said that was racist.
Right.
To stand up.
I just think that it really does showcase what Trump has been saying, which is they hate me because they hate you. And it sounds so divisive, but it's true. Right. Well, otherwise, say, why would you attack
could say,
these
well,
people?
He, it, you know, they could say it was a dark speech, and it's preposterous that he's saying the country's going to go Marxist. But that then, as they're spewing their nonsense on the left-wing cable channels, the people that are leaving the speech
are
being
mobbed.
Attacked
right.
by mobs of Joe Biden supporters, including U.S. senators, including state legislators.
And Howie, I would be remiss if I did not point out that Howie has an incredible column on the website. It's not on the Boston Herald. It's only on our website. It's all about how socialism sucks. It's also in honor of a new T-shirt that we're promoting for this weekend, a very special deal. Go to HowieCarshow.com, read the entire column. All of the links are there for the T-shirt. But Howie really highlights some of the best moments. And you also, what I love is that you tie in the reactions to those moments, which is just mind-boggling when you see some of these, the most American patriotic moments I've ever seen on TV, and people's reactions is so perverse.
These Hollywood stars, I guess it was part of the memo from the DNC, they were comparing Donald Trump to, not to Ronald Reagan or, you know, anyone, any successful president of the past. They were comparing him to Jim Jones.
Oh, but you know, Joe Biden got a lot of Reagan-esque comparisons on the Zoom call. Because that's how everybody remembers Ronald Reagan was on a Zoom call. It's just, it's completely absurd.
919 says, the fireworks were amazing and they weren't shooting them at the cops. That's a good way to put it.
And when we get back, I want to play some of the retired, now unfortunately passed, police officer David Doran. His widow gave an incredible speech yesterday. Some of it was so sad. You could hear the pain in her voice.
And then she was in the audience for the president's speech.
And we got to play a lot of those cuts, Howie, because people need to hear that.
425 says, I have no idea what a blue check person is. Why don't you explain it?
A blue check person is someone on Twitter who is verified as a public figure. And so, yes, Howie's now humbly bragging that he's blue checked. For everyone wondering, I am still not blue checked. But I just want to say, I don't even want it anymore. Okay, Twitter? I don't even want it.
You're going to be a parlor girl?
What does that mean?
That parlor. That's the other one. That's
I thought that was some sort of slur.
That's the Republican Twitter.
I thought there was some like 1920 slur. You're going to be a parlor girl.
All right. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
The Howie Carr Show.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Ken's Place in Scarborough, Maine. Stop by today and have one of my favorite world-famous batter-dipped fried clams. They are the best in the world. That's Ken's Place on Route 9 in Scarborough, Maine. Nauset Beach Inn, the only lodging in the Cape Cod National Seashore, has started their fall special. For only $199 a night in October, you can have an ocean view room with two queen beds. Nauset Beach Inn is pet friendly for an additional charge. Social separation is simple. Every room opens to their 4-acre lawn with easy self check-in and out. Reserve your room today and see the beautiful Cape Cod National Seashore before the rooms are all gone. Still a few rooms left in September as well. Reserve now at nausetbeachinn.com.
Hey, Howie. It was amazing how many listeners wanted the Fresh Rest bedding sheets during the Cheap Bastard deal.
We sold out in 10 minutes, but I feel bad for all the listeners that didn't get a set.
I have some good news. Fresh Rest bedding is selling all sheets at 40% off now through September while supplies last.
Oh, that's great. How do they get them?
Go to FreshRestBedding.com. For all orders over $50, you can also get free shipping. Fresh Rest bedding controls dust mites and pet dander. Fresh Rest bedding.
Cory Booker said it best.
There are definitely moments where you listen to Joe Biden and you just wonder.
Here's stumbling and mumbling Bo Biden, Joe Biden.
David Duke, the former leader of the KKK.
The Ku Klux Klan is the Ku Klux Klan.
8 more years of Donald Trump will change America in a fundamental way.
But if Donald Trump is reelected, Freudian slip.
And the demagogues around the world.
We also have a mechanism to control drug prices. Folks at the health department in the United States, HHS.
They would put 720 million million women back in the workforce.
I never ever thought that I'd see what I saw in Charlotte.
Would you or would you not rejoin the TPP, yes or no?
I would not rejoin the TTP.
Well, they're going out and getting G5 and going to dominate. I mean, what are we doing?
The bills that the future president here, that the senator's talking about.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Can you remember any time in your life when you were starstruck?
One time I saw Peter Vesey, the NBA columnist for the New York Post. He was in the Herald sports department. I really liked his column, so I went up and introduced myself to him. Then one time there was Cousin Brucey from WABC, and I used to listen to him driving back and forth between Chapel Hill and Deerfield when I was in college. Everybody on the East Coast listened to him. I couldn't believe that I was in the presence of Cousin Brucey.
Do you ever play bridge anymore?
No, I haven't played bridge in a very long time. Nobody I know plays bridge. I think my bridge days are behind me.
Do you think you'd still be good at it?
I'm not a great bidder, but I know how to count cards. That, to me, is the essence of playing a hand of bridge, is to be able to count cards.
What is a rhino?
Rhino is a Republican in name only. Think Paul Ryan. Oh, think Mitt Romney. Think Jeff Flake.
This is Paul in North Andover, Mass.
This is Luana in Lexington, Massachusetts.
This is Lauren in Augusta, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of ED treatment. GetRoman.com/Howie. Jared, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Charlie Parker become a Democrat or remain a Republican?
That's what we call our governor, because his real name is Charlie Baker, but Joe Biden has named him Charlie Parker. And incidentally, now that I think of it, happy birthday to the real Charlie Parker. This would be his 100th birthday on Saturday. The great bebop jazz saxophonist, a really talented guy.
We're sorry that we call Charlie Baker Charlie Parker.
As
we don't
mean to complaints
disrespect.
About it from jazz fans.
Yeah, but it's a little bit of a dig.
It's on Joe Biden. It's not on us.
Yes.
So what is the what are the results of the poll?
73% say just become a Democrat.
I agree.
Yeah.
Howie, we don't have a lot of time in this segment, so I want to play some cuts from Sergeant Anne Marie Dorn, the widow of David Dorn, who was killed in cold blood during one of the riots that happened. It was probably two months ago.
2 months ago. Was it in the first batch of riots? He was defending a pawn shop that was owned by one of his friends.
So you guys heard probably a lot of her cuts about him being killed in cold blood on live stream, his grandson seeing it on Facebook, not even realizing it was his grandfather who was lying dead on the sidewalk. Just terrible, terrible stuff. But the cut I really want to play, because I'm not sure if we'll get to it again today, is her call to action to people was so powerful, because it was when she started to call out the Black Lives Matter movement and when she started to highlight why it's important that we vote for President Trump. This is cut 26.
My hope is that having you relive it with me now will help shake this country from this nightmare we're witnessing in our cities and bring about positive, peaceful change. How do we get to this point where so many young people are callous and indifferent towards human life? This isn't a video game where you can commit mayhem and then just hit reset and bring all the characters back to life. David is never, never coming back to me. He was murdered by people who didn't know and just didn't care.
Such senseless murder of this man who just retired. He was a police officer for decades, and he had just retired. He was just going to start probably the most wonderful time of his life, enjoying his grandkids and his family.
And they had the shot framed, so you saw his picture right behind her in his uniform with his wearing his cap.
And you have to think to yourself that so many of these people who get up and speak, it's probably so hard. You can hear it in her voice how hard it is for her to talk about. But
it was like the parents of the woman who was killed by the terrorists, by ISIS. They had a tough time. They were tearing up as well.
And there's so many people. There's people, the mothers, the angel moms. There's so many people who come forward and tell their stories and why it's important to them to support Donald Trump. And it's so powerful, because I just think that if, by the grace of God, luckily nothing like this has ever happened to me, but if it had, all I could think about was sharing the story so people understand. Because like that woman said, he's never coming back to her. She relives this nightmare, as she said, every single day. So I just think it was a great night for the RNC, a great week for the RNC, and a great week for America to get these stories out there finally.
But Joe Biden is going to get on top of it in 10 days.
Yeah, after Labor Day.
We'll be right back. I'm Howie Carr.
The last few months have been stressful for many, and it's time to do something for yourself. Recently, Grace reminded me of when I had that bad haircut 4 years ago. It was actually more like a buzz cut. Although it wasn't planned, I'm incredibly grateful to DiStefano Hair Restoration. Everyone was able to see that my hair could really grow back. I was annoyed when I couldn't get a haircut because of the shutdown, but I am happy that I at least have hair to cut once more. You can have the hair you've been thinking about for all these years. Dr. Hines did a great job for me, and he will for you too. To learn more, go to hairman.com. You may have more time on your hands now, so take advantage of it and get the hair you've been wanting for years. People always stop me and say, it looks so natural. DiStefano Hair Restoration has 5 locations in New England and is open for business. For more information on location openings, go to hairman.com. Get the hair you've always wanted.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators.
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm working for you.
To be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about his experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
We all shop online, and now you could do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who do you consider the biggest rhino in the Republican Party?
Probably is Paul Ryan. I wish a Republican were still the Speaker, but Paul Ryan was scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" And I just picked it up and it became a trademark.
Where's your favorite place to go out to eat in Palm Beach?
My favorite place to go in Palm Beach is probably the Honor Bar, which used to be O Bar. And you can get a really great hamburger there. And they have a great coffee machine that brews each cup of coffee individually.
They're outlandish, they're outrageous, and they're hypocrites. They're the women of The View.
Bernie was so menschy in that moment, like a real guy. I actually am aroused by him.
Timothy McVeigh was a Christian. Just saying.
Hitler was a Christian.
Well, he didn't like the Catholics.
Trump needs to be medicated and hospitalized at this point, or he is going to just
kill all of us.
I mean, do we have to wait till the hammer and sickle is on the American flag before we stand up to this guy?
Joy, you've worn blackface.
I did not go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
It was a Halloween party. I went as a beautiful African woman.
You have tanning lotion on, Joy?
A little. I had makeup that was a little bit darker than my skin.
I'm hoping Dr. Jill becomes a Surgeon General. She's a hell of a doctor.
Whoopi, you said Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape.
I know it wasn't rape.
Child molest, maybe? I'm not sure it was something.
It was something else, but I don't believe it was rape.
Hold up!
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. As you know, there was two Antifa types were shot and killed in Kenosha, Wisconsin, on a couple of nights ago. And there was a top story on Yahoo today, was headlined. I'm reading now from one of our texters from Maine. The two men shot and killed while attending a protest for Jacob Blake were a father and a skater who tried to disarm the shooter, unquote.
Very fake news.
He says, I kid you not. You want me to correct that for you? The two men who shot and killed while attending a protest for Jacob Blake were a convicted pedophile sex offender and a burglar who had also been arrested for having a firearm while intoxicated. Is that there? I fixed it. So the New York Times committed a random act of journalism, as Rush Limbaugh calls it today. They looked over all the video, and there's lots of video of the whole scene in Kenosha where the two people were shot and the guy with a gun in his hand was wounded. And the headline is tracking the suspect in the fatal Kenosha shootings. In most of the footage the Times has reviewed from before the shootings, Mr. Rittenhouse, that's the 17-year-old kid who shot them, is around this area. He also offers medical assistance to protesters. Goes down a little bit more. While Mr. Rittenhouse is being pursued by the group, this is by the, you and I would call it a mob, but they're calling it a group. An unknown gunman fires into the air, though it's unclear why. Why does one usually fire a gun, New York Times? Think it through. The weapon's muzzle flash appears in footage filmed at the scene. Mr. Rittenhouse, again, this is the 17-year-old from Antioch, Illinois, turns toward the sound of the gunfire as another pursuer lunges towards him from the same direction. Mr. Rittenhouse then fires four times and appears to shoot the man in the head. I think that's Rosenbaum. That's the pedophile. As Mr. Rittenhouse is running, he trips and falls to the ground. He fires four shots as three people rush towards him. One person appears to be hit in the chest and falls to the ground. Another, who was carrying a handgun, the New York Times admitted this. That's significant that the New York Times would actually allow all the news that's fit to print to actually be printed. Another, who was carrying a handgun, is hit in the arm and runs away. He set up a GoFundMe page, that guy. Not raising a lot of money, but he set it up. 844-500-4242. Tom, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Tom. You there, Tom? No, guess not. Tim, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Tim.
Yeah, I'm next. Just two items. Trump got to get on the bandwagon here. We're hearing Biden might try to bang in sick, whether by faking it or self-inflicting the virus to himself. And with Pelosi telling him she should get out of it, you know, nothing.
Well, Tim, Pelosi changed her mind today. She went out and said, "Oh no, I wasn't saying he shouldn't debate. I have full confidence in him." So that was one of the flip flops by the Democrats today. The other one was by Kamala Harris, And she was asked on the Today Show, what's up with this national mask mandate? It's I guess it must not be focus group testing very well. So she said, oh, no, there are not going to be any penalties. So if there are no penalties, Tim, what kind of mandate is it?
Howie, even better than that, she was questioned about calling Biden a sexual predator, and she walked that one back by saying, oh, it was just a debate. And then she laughs. It's a cackle, just like Hillary's cackle. You got to find that piece. these people have no honor, Howie, but that's something you want to find.
Yeah. No, we'll look for that. Thanks for the call, Tim. 844-500-4242. Stephen, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Stephen.
Hey, how are you, Howie?
Good.
Yeah, there was a video there of the Kenosha rally pushing a fence down. A woman was shouting, "Death to America." I mean, these are the phrases I never thought I would hear within America.
Right. And well, the guy Rosenbaum that got shot, he was chanting the N word at Rittenhouse, who's white, and you know they were. In Washington last night, outside the White House, they were chanting the N-word at Representative Vernon Jones from Georgia, who's been on this show a couple of times. We're trying to get him on. He's booked up solid, but we're trying to get him on at some point during the day here. Go ahead, Stephen.
He's a Democrat.
Yeah, he is. He's a Democrat, right. Yeah.
Yeah. Sounds like a good man.
He is a good man. He's a very good man. And you know, they're saying...
Hopefully he changed parties.
Well, you know what they're saying, Stephen? Well, you know, he's not a real Democrat. He voted for George W. Bush in 2000 and 2004. So, you know, if somebody like Jeff Flake or Colin Powell or John Kasich goes over to the other side, even though they were rhinos to begin with, they're treated as profiles in courage. But, you know, if you go the other way, they want to run you out of town. Or they scream at you as they screamed at Vernon Jones last night. And again, how many incidents, attacks is Rand Paul, the senator from Kentucky, going to have to put up with? He almost got killed by the Bernie bro at the Republican baseball practice where Steve Scalise, their congressman from Louisiana, got shot. Then he gets attacked while he's mowing his own lawn outside his own house. By this nut doctor who was convicted of a felony, who I think his lung collapsed and his ribs were broken, and now he almost gets assaulted last night. He said if the Metro cops hadn't been around, he said the mob would have jumped him and his wife and the two women that were with him, and he said they would have, God only knows what would have happened. You know, 10-on-1 is Democrat fun. And at some point, he said the mob at one point grew to about 100 people. 100-on-1, that's extra Democrat fun. Thanks for the call, Stephen. Robert, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Robert.
Thank you, Mr. Carr, for having me. I'm a 72-year-old South Carolinian, and I just got a question for Beijing Biden.
Yeah.
I had to take out a student loan several years ago. I had to work two different jobs, and I was in the reserve one weekend a month. What I'd like to know is he's giving out all this money to all these other people that don't want to pay it. I want a refund on what I paid with interest.
A lot of people would like refunds with interest, Robert. A lot of people that have paid off all their student loans. Yeah, you're right. But you're not going to get it if you work the working class. Let me put it that way. Only the non-working class, I should say, is going to benefit from the Democrats' plans to tax the rich. Tax the rich. That's what they say. There's a guy named Antoine Tucker. He's running in the 14th congressional district in New York. And he's a black guy, and he's put up a video. He tweeted out a video of himself talking to people who he's trying to explain to black voters in his congressional district why they should not vote for Joe Biden and why they should vote for Donald Trump. It's pretty funny stuff here. We're going to play it. Antoine, I think that's how he pronounces his name, Antoine Tucker, and he's running for Congress in the 14th Congressional District in New York. I think it's New York City. Cut 7.
mean, she was going off. She was screaming. She said, Trump's a racist. She said he wanted segregation. And then I had to give her that red pill. So now you know he did prison reform, right?
Correct.
Okay, so now you know that he gave black historical colleges more funding than anyone else in history and made sure they would never have to ask for another dollar again, right?
Correct.
Now you know that he gave the Urban Revitalization Coalition a $100 billion starting budget to fix impoverished communities throughout America, effectively helping out black and brown communities. Okay, so now that we have all of this established, now let me give you some more tips. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump received an award with Rosa Parks and Muhammad Ali for helping black folks. Donald Trump funded Jesse Jackson's presidential races both times and helped fund the Rainbow Coalition.
Oh yeah, the LGBTQ.
So how could Donald Trump be racist and care and do all of that back work? See, it wasn't until I told her who Danny Williams was and showed her that, that it started to click. And it wasn't until she went and looked up Biden's history and she seen Biden ain't. We going to give our vote to Trump because we realize these folks are trying to f*** us over and we not stupid.
I wasn't voting for Biden anyway, though.
Quote of the day, I wasn't voting for Biden anyway. That's good to know. You weren't voting for Biden anyway. Here's President Trump last night on the competing visions from for America. Cut 34.
At no time before have voters faced a clearer choice between two parties, two visions, two philosophies, or two agendas. This election will decide whether we save the American dream or whether we allow a socialist agenda to demolish our cherished destiny.
Buddy, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, buddy.
All right.
You there?
Yes, I'm here.
Go ahead.
I want to know why Americans can't get along with each other. I have three biracial grandchildren. They are half Mexican.
Yeah.
I have one that is half black. And if I'm an American, if somebody hurts one of my grandchildren, they got me to deal with. So why can't people just get along?
Well, that's what Rodney King asked so many years ago during the Los Angeles riots back in the 90s. It seems like one side is fomenting this discord a lot more than the other side, doesn't it, buddy?
Yes, it does. I'm sitting here talking to you. My mother's in the hospital. She's been up there for 3 days. We don't know whether she's coming home. But I want to know, when is this country going to be a country again?
I don't know. That's a very good question, buddy. And I don't know that anyone knows the answer to that question. It's going to require a little more civility, and that includes outside the White House. When people are leaving the White House, you don't call gay people the F word. You don't call black people the N word, like the Joe Biden supporters were doing last night as people left the speech on the South Lawn of the White House. I hope your mother is can recover, buddy. Thanks for calling in. 844-500-4242. Everyone needs a great pair of wireless earbuds right now. And you already know that Raycon earbuds start at about half the price of any other premium wireless earbuds on the market, and that they sound just as amazing as other top audio brands that you know. Their newest model, the Everyday E25 earbuds, are their best ones yet, with 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a nice noise-isolating fit. Raycon's wireless earbuds are so comfortable, perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Everybody loves Raycon earbuds. I got some last spring. I gave some to Grace for her birthday. She gave some to her father for Father's Day. Her sister loved them so much, she got some. Her fiance bought some. When you get Raycon wireless earbuds, pretty soon everybody in your family, your close circle of friends, and the people you work with, they're going to want them too. That's how good they are. Unlike some of the other wireless options, Raycon earbuds are both stylish and discreet with no dangling wires or stems. You've heard me talk about how the company was co-founded by Ray J, and celebrities like J.R. Smith are obsessed with Raycons, just like the Curley family. Now's the time to see what the hype is all about. Get 15% off your order at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie for 15% off Raycon wireless earbuds. Buyraycon.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment.
This is going to sound immodest, but I'm obviously a top-tier candidate. I've had a lot of titles over my career, and certainly vice president will be great, but Mamala will always be the one that means the most. They said, well, do you think Trump is responsible for what happened? And I said, well, look, I mean, obviously he didn't pull the trigger, but he's certainly been tweeting out the ammunition. And that's why do gotta go. What else do we know about this population, 18 through 24? They are stupid. That is why we put them in dormitories.
You know, I'm just gonna engage in real talk. I don't wanna waste your time.
What is your favorite musical genre?
I'm hip-hop and reggae and jazz. Those are some of my favorites.
Okay.
Have you ever smoked?
I have.
Okay.
Back in college, I inhale. I did inhale.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. I've seen a lot of Anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Tenney says, if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that here in Jerusalem, and okay. It's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second, control room? Not gunshots? Okay.
Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position. She's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk about the first lady that way. We aren't all here to make salads for men. It's disgusting.
I mean, I'm presuming he was talking about Karen Pence when he said second lady.
I'm sorry.
Not Montana. I'm talking about never mind.
Yeah, no, Chester.
Montana and North Dakota confused because, I don't know, I just was.
This is Lynn in sunny Las Vegas.
This is Dan from the Moonbat capital of Jamaica Plain.
This is Gigi in Leominster, Massachusetts, and this is The Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of The Howie Carr Show. If you'd like to join us, I'm just looking at some more cuts here. Let's play Anne-Marie Dorn, the widow of David Dorn, who was slain outside the pawn shop that he was trying to protect. He was a retired police officer. This is Anne-Marie Dorn calling out Black Lives Matter. Cut 27.
Violence and destruction are not legitimate forms of protest.
They do not safeguard black lives. They only destroy them. President Trump understands this, has offered federal help to restore order in our communities. In a time when police departments are short on resources and manpower, we need that help. We should accept that help. We must heal before we can effect change, but we cannot heal amid devastation and chaos. President Trump knows we need more Davids in our communities, not fewer. We need to come together in peace and remember that every life is precious.
Scotty, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Scotty.
Hey, Howie.
Hi.
So, all this stuff that's going on in our country, what do you think about our political divides between Democrats and Republicans and, like, what we've maybe imported, because I'm a veteran, the Shia and Sunni divides in their own countries?
What you mean? We're turning. You mean like Republicans and Democrats are turning into Shia and Sunni, and who are always killing each other? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. How he's going down the drain, man.
Yeah. It certainly seems like it's not like it was 30 or 40 years ago when you would win or lose an election. If you lost the election, you wouldn't try to impeach or frame the person who won. You wouldn't say that you had to change the system, abolish the Electoral College, allow 16-year-olds to vote, allow felons to vote. You hitched up your pants and dusted yourself off and said, I got to do better next time. I don't know what the answer is, Scotty. It's same thing with the previous caller. I don't know what the answer is to this kind of this environment of just total outrage. I just think that the Dems, though, are more angry than the Republicans. I mean, the Republicans, I think, still believe in freedom of speech. I mean, President Trump was talking last night about the speech codes, and it's pretty amazing, isn't it, that a president of the United States would talk about the threat of speech codes in the United States. And of course, speech codes are a total violation of the First Amendment in the Bill of Rights. Thanks for the call, Scotty. Judy, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Judy.
Yes, there was a couple things quick. One, I was just kind of amazed when I was watching the end of the inauguration, when Rand Paul came out and his wife and the other senator and his wife. I was feeling scared for them because they were scared. You could tell it. The police were trying to
absolutely
get them away.
Yeah.
And you know, but you know what I was amazed at is what he said later and on the news today. Who are these people? What are they doing? How are they doing this?
Well, he was saying that the feds, the FBI, the Justice Department need to investigate who's paying these people because they're being bussed into the city, he thinks, into D.C. The Kenosha, Wisconsin police today announced that they've arrested the 9 people that came in from out of state, and their cars were full of all sorts of weapons. I'm Howie Carr.
If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
President Trump is clearly ethically unfit and intellectually unprepared to be the president of the United States.
And I support Chairman Woman. In the coming weeks, the House will hold hearings. Senator Harris.
He's our president, and I would rather he not be taking something that has not been approved, especially in his age group and in his, shall we say, weight group, what is morbidly obese, they say.
So completely inappropriate in so many ways that it's almost a given. It's like a child who comes in with mud on their pants or something. That's the way it is. They're outside playing. That's what it is. He comes in with doggy do on his shoes, and everybody who works with him has that on their shoes too. But I only will do that if you tell me that this legislation is worthy of George Kirby's name. This movement of moment of national anguish.
Whether it's global warming, global cooling, or climate change, one thing's for certain, the progressive moonbats can't stop talking about it.
We're talking about cities all over the world, major cities going underwater.
You know, I've spent a lot of time now with these young students, and they're scared. And a lot of young people are even suffering from, they're calling it extinction illness.
So that we can have people here who truly are committed to climate change, believe in climate change as though it's a religion, it's not a science.
A woman whose dreams of motherhood now taste bittersweet because of what I know about our children's future.
You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words.
That curing cancer is going to be much more difficult when there's so much climate change and pollutants in the environment, because a lot of cancer is environmentally caused.
Recognizing and acknowledging the link between animal agriculture and climate change is a very bold move, making tonight plant-based.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a 2-year contract. You just order online, set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more, all for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I have let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN. All right. And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
If I may ask one other question. Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up, and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is... Your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? And, like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
You might hear a lot about Bernie, Biden, and Elizabeth Warren, but what about the lightweights who are running for president? Here's a best of the B team.
I've listened to some of my colleagues, Mr. Glover, tell you how much they like your movies. And I have to say, we didn't come here to talk about your movies. We came here to talk about your activism. I like your activism. I also like your movies, but I want to give you a chance because I haven't heard the other side other than tell you that they like your movies.
I think the NRA is the worst organization in this country for doing exactly that. They care more about the profits than the American people.
I learned a long time ago about polling. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. I mean, right now, I got nowhere to go but up.
Millions living in the shadows, working some of the toughest jobs, kept in modern-day bondage.
People commit crime. Crime happens.
I have won every single congressional district in my state, including Michelle Bachmann's, okay? That's when you guys are supposed to cheer.
You've been hearing me talk about Super Beats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Super Beats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Super Beats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Super Beats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm someone working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the second.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
At no time before have voters faced a clearer choice between two parties, two visions, two philosophies, or two agendas.
Let's choose. Let's choose wisely.
This election will decide whether we save the American dream or whether we allow a socialist agenda to demolish our cherished destiny.
For one chance, just one chance, and tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
And you talked about the national mask mandate. It sounds like that would be one of the first orders of business.
Yes.
How would you enforce that?
It's really a standard. I mean, nobody's going to be punished. Come on.
Then as of this moment, they're on double secret probation.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
As I slept, looters were ransacking the shop.
Peacefully protesting in the streets.
They shot and killed David in cold blood.
Protests have been mostly peaceful there.
And then live streamed his execution and his last moments on Earth.
Peaceful protesters.
David's grandson was watching the video on Facebook in real time, not realizing he was watching his own grandfather dying on the sidewalk.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Washington has not changed Donald Trump. Donald Trump has changed Washington.
Always remember, they are coming after me because I am fighting for you. That's what's happening.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
I always thought of a mandate as an order. And I seem to recall Joe Biden a couple of days ago talking about a national mask mandate. And I seem to recall Rick Grenell at the Republican convention saying, you have a choice here in this election between someone who wants to force you to wear a mask and someone who doesn't want to force you to wear a mask. So now we find out today that the mandate is not really a mandate under the traditional definition of a mandate. In other words, an order. It's just a suggestion. You know, just a suggestion. It's something you might want to do. But, and then she goes on to say, well, you know, nobody likes wearing a mask. No kidding. Why do you think Rick Grenell put that out as a stark contrast between the two campaigns? But it's a suggestion. It's not a national mask mandate. It's a national mask suggestion. Suggestion. All right, time now for the Chump Line. That's not the only flip-flop of the day. We'll play the other one with Nancy Pelosi in just a bit.
Let me tell you a little story of a man named Joe, demented politician with no place to go. Then one day he wants to be president. Obama's endorsement just get bent. Socialists, puppeteers, the Joe Biden Show.
That, of course, is from the Beverly Hillbillies, and there was a spinoff from the Beverly Hillbillies, a couple of them, actually, I guess, and one of them was Petticoat Junction. And the theme song, that is, includes the famous lyrics, there's Uncle Joe, he's a moving kind of slow at the junction. Wilmington Junction.
Parker pledged he would fight for us bare-knuckled. That soon became BS as he consistently buckled. COVID came along, he did everything wrong, and when confronted with the facts, the rhino chuckled.
Yes, he did. As the news keeps coming in that, for instance, the CDC says that, testing really doesn't mean much, that quarantines aren't quite appropriate for this plague, that everybody is testing negative. Did you notice that fewer and fewer are the days when he calls a press conference on a coronavirus update? There was one this week. Count them, one update. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, looking forward to the Republican National Convention. Well, it's over now, but this was written earlier. Unlike the positive, uplifting messages from last week's DNC, we expect to be hearing somber, pessimistic, and otherwise sobering talks about the future of our country. At least we're pretty sure that's how it will be reported. It will also be reported that President Trump was committing crimes by having that ceremony last night in the White House on the South Lawn, which was only to be expected, wasn't it?
Howie, Joe Biden calling. Come on, man. I don't need a flashy acceptance speech. The fact is, catchy slogans are the new in thing, like Cleveland Steve or Tippy Canoe and Tyler Too. The only one I can think of for my ticket, though, is Hair Plugs and Harris. I mean it.
Hair Plugs and Harris. Yes. He was one of the first guys, I think, to get a hair transplant. And it looked it. It looked like it was some kind of clinical trial. And you had to get these things. And they were literally plugs in those days. Literally plugs. And therefore his nickname, Plugs Biden.
Hey, Howie. Did Charlie Parker get his name from combining Charlie Gasco and Richard Parker? It certainly seems like Charlie Parker is ruining the state economy like a cold-blooded, ruthless crime boss.
I would say more like a serial killer. That's what's rather ironic about him suggesting that everybody get out this weekend and shop till you drop. Where the hell do you expect us to shop till we drop when you've put probably a third of the businesses in the Commonwealth under?
His name is Biden. Worlds are colliding. in the basement where he has been hiding from the Donald, the mighty Trumpster. And Joe, while lined up in the dumpster, Joe fears the big debate because he cannot mentate in the basement where he is hiding. That gaff machine known as Joe Biden, he's lost his mind.
We'll let that one go tonight, but if you want to do one on Monday, you got to call him Bidden. That's his new name from the tweet that came out today. The woman saying, I wasn't going to vote for Bidden anyway. It's forbidden to vote for Bidden if you know what you're talking about.
Don't you love how the Gaslight News Networks criticize Trump from using a teleprompter while reading from their teleprompters?
Yes, there was a great moment today on Fox and Friends. Geraldo was on there, and they were talking about what it was at the White House and all this criticism. And Geraldo said, "Yeah, I talked to him a couple of weeks ago, and I said, why don't you do the acceptance speech in the lobby of the hotel, you know, which is right down the street from the White House, or go to the golf club in New Jersey and do it from there." And Trump just said to Geraldo, "You know what? They're going to criticize me anyway. So why don't I just do it at the best place of all, the White House?" That's it. That's exactly right. They were going to criticize him. It didn't matter if he'd gone. He's going to the hotel, and he charged the country for that hotel, the security, and he made some money off it. Same thing they would have said at the golf club in Jersey.
Yes, Joe was blinded by the right. He came up from his basement in the middle of the night.
No, I think they lock him in a secure facility once night falls, because they don't want him wandering around in the dark on the stairs. He might fall down and hurt himself. Good Lord. 844-500-4242. 413 says, the White House is the Trump's home. Everyone is allowed to have get-togethers in their backyard. Well, yeah. At least as long as their last name is Polito. His last name isn't Polito.
The other day, Charlie Baker was asking people on tax-free weekend to shop in small local businesses. Are there any left in this state?
Exactly. Yeah, that's my point. Thinking about writing a column about this for the weekend. I'm going to need those cuts about him exhorting people to spend big money this weekend on your local Main Street shops, of which there are a lot fewer than there were a few months ago.
With Charlie Parker, it's not a matter if he should become a Democrat. It's a matter of if he should admit he's a Democrat.
Exactly. Exactly. We talked about it earlier this week. He has a new super PAC that he set up. He raised like $1.2 million for it, $1,200,000. And he's passing out all the money, mostly maybe 80-90% to Democrats in these primary elections. 90% to Democrats, not Republicans.
Joe Biden said Hunter is going to help him study for his drug test.
I really hope the president expounds on his demand that Joe Biden take a drug test before the debates.
Cocaine is a hell of a drug.
I was trying to plant that suggestion in Corey Lewandowski a little bit earlier in the day.
Hey, Rudy, could you speak a little louder, please? Kimberly Guilfoyle can't quite hear you.
Yeah, Rudy seemed a little jacked up last night, didn't he? I mean, I like Rudy, and his points were all well taken. But, you know, he could have remembered that TV is a cool medium. You know, it was like he was on the back of a flatbed truck in Canarsie the night before the election against David Dinkins in, I don't know, 1993.
Iremia Carr, you got it all wrong. Joe doesn't want to win this election now. Around with the bar still closed, it's much more lucrative for him to go back to the family business. Bootlegging. Yeah.
Senator, did you finally get some stuff down where you are? Ah, that's good. I'm glad. It's been a long, dry 11 years, hasn't it?
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
All right, that's it for the Chump Line today. The Chump Line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night, including weekends. The Chump Line number, if you'd like to leave such a message, 844-500-4242. I should say the Chump Line is open from 1 to 5 every weekday. You can leave it anytime on a weekday after 1 o'clock. We've shut it down a little bit, but we're still getting a lot of good messages, so it's okay, I think. Press 2 for the Chump Line when you get through and leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. If we don't play it now, we may put it together in a podcast. We do Chop Chumps, the podcast, every weeknight. It's put up there after the show ends. Get your Chop Chumps wherever you get your Howie Carr Show podcasts. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, we were enjoying the Republican National Convention. Unlike the positive, uplifting messages from last week's DNC, we heard somber, pessimistic, and otherwise sobering talks about the future of our country. At least, we're pretty sure that's how it will be reported. Don't forget, too, there were also illegal gatherings on the White House South Lawn last night, and it was a dark message, ominous message, disturbing message that was delivered by President Trump. Just ask him. Just ask all the Democrat operatives with press passes.
Joe Biden said Hunter is going to help him study for his drug test.
I'm sure he is. 844-500-4242. 919 says the mayor of Raleigh, North Carolina, is putting a curfew in effect from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. tonight and tomorrow night. Why? I thought all these protests were mostly peaceful. Yeah. I guess, you know, it's sometimes people after dark and it gets harder for the police to see you and harder for the surveillance cameras to pick you up. Sometimes the mostly peaceful demonstrators turn into mostly peaceful looters and arsonists. I'm Howie Carr.
They call him the Trash Man, but we'll call him Captain Howie Carr.
Campers, are you thinking about getting a new or used RV this year? This is Howie Carr, and Cold Springs RV is ready for you. The 2021 models are now arriving daily, but they won't last long. After one visit, you will understand why they are a one-stop shop for all things camping. With all the top RV brands, a new state-of-the-art service center, a new RV body shop, and a huge store full of accessories, you don't need to go anywhere else. If it is service you need, the brand new state-of-the-art service facility is ready for you. They service all makes and brands. If your RV needs body work, they have you covered. They can help you with collision repair, roof replacement, or even a new paint job. From minor repairs to major insurance jobs, Cold Springs RV can do it all. As a full-service RV dealer, you know they can fix just about anything. If you are a service technician and want to work for the best, ask about employment today. Cold Springs RV, Route 114 in Ware, New Hampshire. ColdSpringsRV.com, your destination for all things camping.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him late for dinner. He's Howie Carr.
We will bring over your entire family from the third world Muslim hellhole that they live in so that they can have an all expenses paid, taxpayer funded with open bar weekend at a nice hotel in Boston. Get a nice sightseeing tour, maybe take them to Fenway Park for a game. So they can see their savage Muslim terrorist kinsman sentenced to death. But the President of the United States of America can't be allowed to speak before Parliament because he's such a terrible barbarian, as opposed to the dictator of Red China. And I'm going to call it Red China. Since the Dems are down on Russia, we might as well go after all the communist dictatorships that are left, right? Russia isn't even a communist dictatorship, it's just authoritarian now, but let's call it Red China.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's Everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people.
They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden.
But no, I because the we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
This is Jay in Hingham, Massachusetts.
This is Gloria from Haverhill, Mass.
Hi, this is Joe from Howie in the Hills, Florida. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
And it wasn't until she went and looked up Biden's history and she seen Biden ain't. We gonna give our vote to Trump because we realize these folks are trying to f*** us over and we not stupid.
I wasn't voting for Biden anyway, though.
I love that CNN fact checker. How dare he say that he's done more for black people than anyone since Abraham Lincoln? What about LBJ? And someone texted me to remind me that, when LBJ passed the war on poverty, said, this'll have them, and I don't know what word, he used, voting for us, voting Democrat for the next 200 years. That was his commitment to civil rights, LBJ. And how has the war on poverty worked out for all Americans? Increasing welfare dependency, encouraging the breakdown of the nuclear family among all ethnic groups. It's been a disaster. Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment. GetRoman.com/Howie. Jared, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Charlie Parker become a Democrat or remain a Republican?
Become a Democrat.
Just become a Democrat.
Come out of the closet, Charlie.
That just become a Democrat is in at 78%.
I knew it would increase. That was a fluke that first time we did it. 978. I'm taking advantage of my tax-free weekend by going to Four Seasons in Woburn and buying a firearm. You can go to Cape Gunworks too and get a firearm. We're gonna have Toby on with us a little bit later. We have an announcement to make about an appearance next week, but we'll tell you more about that later. Okay. Nancy Pelosi yesterday basically said Joe Biden shouldn't debate Donald Trump, and that didn't go over real well. She was a little too open in releasing the Democrats' plan. I don't know how they were planning to roll it out, how slowly. First, there was going to be some columnists for the New York Times, but she had to back down today. Here it is.
Well, I have every confidence in Joe Biden. As I've said, he knows why. He knows his why. Why I said he shouldn't debate him has nothing to do with Joe Biden.
Oh, of course
Biden,
it does.
Will be great as he is great as a debater.
Oh, yeah.
Can we fact check her faith in Joe Biden?
Can we hook her up to a lie detector test for that entire statement, Madam Speaker? Would that be okay? And here's Geraldo talking about his conversation with Trump about where they should hold the acceptance speech. Remember, he was originally going to deliver the acceptance speech in Charlotte, but then the Democrat governor of North Carolina shut that down. So he moved to Jacksonville, Florida, where they have a Republican governor and a Republican mayor in Jacksonville. They nixed it. So then he was going to go to Gettysburg and do it at the site of the famous Civil War battle. They nixed it. So what the hell was he going to do? So here's Geraldo.
Conversation about it 2 weeks ago. I said, why not the executive office building? Why not the lobby of the Trump Grand Hotel a couple of blocks away? He said he'd be criticized regardless of the venue. Why not choose the grandest of them all? And look at the show he put on. Those fireworks were amazing.
Exactly. I'm Howie Carr. AmeriClean Sanitizing is providing state-of-the-art sanitation for your home or business. Using the HaloSil fogging system, it is able to kill 428 different viruses, including COVID. Hospitals have been using the HaloSil fogging system for years, and now you can too. The fog sanitizes everything, including keyboards, under the desk, and even HVAC systems. To schedule an appointment or learn more, go to AmeriCleanSanitizing.com. Take a look at their videos at AmeriCleanSanitizing.com and see how easy it is to kill the virus.
The Bayview Collection is a small group of distinctive luxury boutique hotels located in the beautiful coastal village of Camden, Maine, whose properties include the Lord Camden Inn, Camden's premier downtown boutique hotel, the Grand Harbor Inn, Camden's only Four Diamond Waterfront Hotel, and 16 Bayview, Camden's newest contemporary hotel property with its iconic rooftop bar, The View. The Bayview Collection, three great choices, one remarkable destination. To learn more, visit them at BayviewCollection.com.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time.
I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? Oh, that's a goody two-shoes favorite curse word if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, organized by...
You have to figure out
who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class.
And my Aunt Bee has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians did.
Here's 1 minute with Governor
Charlie Parker in Massachusetts.
I'd certainly put myself on that list. I'm a basketball player. I always was.
There's a lot at stake here.
This is not a virus to be trifled with or disrespected.
Respect the virus.
I have a hard time understanding when we're going to be able to play basketball again.
We can start talking about a gradual, careful, data-driven, phased reopening. Don't let a few nice days...
Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen? And the reason I read that story is because I'm a basketball player and I agree.
I was first made aware of the discrepancy on this on the day that the registrar resigned.
The vast majority, and I mean like the vast majority of the people who are part of these protests are there to make a point and to make it peacefully. That is so obvious, I'm amazed that anybody could say anything other than that. I would love to be able to open everything up tomorrow. That would be an incredibly irresponsible thing to do.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I wrote a column on my thoughts about the Republican convention, and it's only posted on the website, the show website, HowieCarrShow.com, and you can read it there. And we also, at HowieCarrShow.com, in the store, we have a special for the tax-free weekend. We have a new t-shirt, Socialism Sucks. Socialism Sucks. If you order the Socialism Sucks t-shirt in whatever size, up this from small to 2XL, you'll also get a free autographed copy of my book, What Really Happened. That'll be included, and there will be no sales tax on your purchase. It's a great deal. This is only through the weekend with no taxes. So Socialism Sucks t-shirt. It's a nice t-shirt. Check it out when you check out my column about the convention. And HowieCarrShow.com. Click on the store. It's a good deal. All right, it's that time of the week. It's Friday evening, the third hour of the show. You know what time that means. It is.
Whenever the laws of any state are broken, a duly authorized organization swings into action.
All week long, we ask you to send in your funny stories or items from your local daily or weekly newspaper. Many newspapers have police columns. They call it the police log, the police blotter. That's where we found out the item about the former ambassador to Portugal, the gold-digging Elizabeth Bagley, being arrested for drunk driving. You got to check out your local columns to find out such prurient, humorous information. So send any funny items, or it can be a standalone story from the local newspaper or the website or your internet connections. Send it to grace@howiecarshow.com, grace@howiecarshow.com, or you can still fax them to us at 857-284-8864, 857-284-8864. And at this time, every Friday evening, we read the funniest ones of the week, in our opinion, and the two best entries of the week, the two funniest entries of the week, get a nice prize. What do they get this week, Grace?
They will get a copy of your fabulous book, What Really Happened? The story of how Donald J. Trump became President Donald J.
Right.
Trump.
But if you want to get a Socialism Sucks t-shirt, you can also get a copy of What Really Happened for free.
And you don't even have to send us a crazy naked man story. You just go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on Howie's latest. Okay, guys, so here are the runners-up. They do not win a prize. Man pours syrup on his girlfriend's car door, cracks windshield with bottle. Now, before you ask, I know what you're going to say. I do not know the brand of syrup. I'm not sure if it was store brand, if it was real Vermont maple syrup.
I'm wondering about cracking the windshield with a bottle. That might have to be a pretty heavy bottle. I would think most bottles would just
splinter and crack themselves, the window would be okay.
But I think it was the bottle of syrup that cracked it. So I think it might have been one of those, you know, hard jugs like the one we have in the fridge.
Yeah.
Where you can grab the handle and kind of give it a nice whack.
Where did this happen?
This happened in Nashville. 26-year-old James L.
Didn't happen in Vermont where they had some local stuff?
No. But, I mean, people love syrup everywhere, so.
Was this real syrup or was this some kind of corn fructose, fructose or toast, whatever they are?
Well, the reason I think it was real syrup is because if the bottle was heavy enough, it's not going to be, you know, a Mrs. Buttersworth. Those bottles are pretty much made of plastic nowadays.
Yeah.
They don't tend to come in glass. So my journalistic instincts say
Vermont made. Surely you can still get a glass bottle of Vermont made.
26-year-old James L. Hawkins was charged.
James L.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Was charged with vandalism when he became angry during an argument with his girlfriend and dumped syrup over her car before cracking her windshield with the bottle. The exchange occurred between James L. Hawkins Jr. and Jasmine Davis. They have a child together.
Are they engaged?
It says,
is he an aspiring rapper?
It says Davis advised police that he was upset because she had picked up the children.
The children?
Which is strange because usually I feel like a fight would break out if you didn't pick up the kids. But in this case, the fight broke out because someone did pick up the kids.
How dare you bring the kids home?
Okay, the next story is wild. Okay, this, I don't know how I haven't seen this until today. Mayoral, and if you already read this, Howie, just interrupt me. Mayoral candidate stages kidnapping on Facebook in plot to gain votes.
No, I'm not familiar with this story.
Okay, I got to walk you guys through this. And there's a question, Howie, in this story that I think you're going to ask, but you won't find it in this piece of literature.
I won't find the answer, you mean.
Right. A candidate in a crowded South Carolina.
I already got it.
Dun, 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 dun.
Is he a Democrat or is he a Republican?
Well, first
or is
of all,
he a member of the Prohibition Party or the Greenback Party?
First of all, Sabrina Belcher is a woman.
Sabrina Belcher. That's quite the name. Is she from Belchertown?
She's accused of orchestrating an elaborate ruse for sympathy votes. I know, that's a good word.
Were the police baffled by the elaborate ruse?
No, I think they figured it out pretty fast. Here's the thing. When you fake a kidnapping, especially nowadays, it unravels very quickly because of technology. Christopher James Eady was also charged.
Cell phones, surveillance cameras, all that kind of stuff.
Was also charged with conspiracy in the case. So they staged a kidnapping and beating in order to garner publicity, sympathy, and votes in the November election. Belcher met with officers.
I thought this was a primary election. What, no one's going to remember a kidnapping that happened in August and November.
Well, Howie, we're giving Joe Biden grief for not campaigning enough. At least Sabrina's on top of her game here. She's trying to get ahead of it. Belcher met with officers just before 11:30 p.m. Tuesday and told them she had been assaulted and kidnapped by an unknown man during an attempted robbery. She also said the man had knocked out the windows of her car.
With maple syrup?
Doesn't say. I was trying
to. A lot
of
that going around in the South, apparently.
I was trying to draw the connection.
Okay.
Police said Belcher was taken to a nearby hospital for injuries, was later released. Belcher had tried to discredit a fellow candidate. They also said she had ongoing plans to smear other mayoral candidates prior to the election. It wasn't immediately clear how the ruse was unraveled.
Was she going to, you know, fire bullets into her house or something? Or paint some nasty slurs on the front door? What was she going to do?
It says, but police said investigators learned Belcher had given a fake name for the man she believed had attacked her. A George Glass type of situation. So here's Howie. I'm going to let you guess what answer will not be found in this story.
Well, the party affiliation.
I had to go to like 7 different stories.
Yeah.
To find out the answer.
And she's a Democrat.
Which tells you the answer.
Right.
She's a Democrat.
She's a Democrat.
All right.
By the way, Grace, can I give you something?
Of course
former,
you can.
Former UAW president, United Auto Workers president, has been charged with embezzlement. Dennis Williams. And you say, wait a second, Howie, isn't this an old story? No, you're getting Dennis Williams, who's been charged with embezzlement, with another former UAW president by the name of Gary Jones, who's already pleaded guilty to embezzlement and racketeering.
This sounds like Beacon Hill.
Yeah, these guys in just one of the years of the conspiracies, Jones, he's the first one, used
United Auto Workers money to purchase over $13,000 in cigars.
Ooh, Tony Soprano style. Woke up this morning.
You could get a tobacco farm for less than $13,000.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Either they got an awful lot of cigars or they liked very expensive cigars, or I'm thinking both.
You can buy Cuba for $13,000.
All right. Plymouth police searching for highly aggressive 2,000-pound beefalo on the loose.
In Plymouth?
Plymouth, Connecticut.
Oh. Well, still. I didn't know there were any beefalo in New England.
I didn't know there was such a thing as beefalo until today.
Ted Turner used to have a restaurant, maybe he still does, in New York City, slaughter the beefalo in his on his ranch out in Montana.
That's
or
crazy
Idaho somewhere,
because the beefalo's name was Ted.
That's probably yeah. People say it's really good. You know what a beefalo is, right?
Yes, I do. Beefalo is a cross between a bison and a domestic cattle.
Right.
This one was 2,000 pounds, and I guess it's highly aggressive. If you can believe that, so he's on the loose, Howie. So watch yourself tonight when you go on your daily nightly walks. Look out for the beefalo.
He's aggressive, but mostly peaceful.
Yes. Thank you, Jared. How dare I? Woman tackles robber.
You won't be dangerous as long as you don't get between a beefalo and a liquor store.
Oh, by the way, guys, Police Blotter Facts Friday, as always, is brought to you by Piantedosi Baking Company, celebrating over 100 years of baking excellence since 1916. Howie loves Piantedosi bread. I love Piantedosi bread. They have all different kinds. They have, you know, the sliced bread. They have the French bread, the long baguettes. Everything is delicious. Check them out at your local markets.
Did you see that a district attorney in California, I think it's Contra Costa County, something like that, has instructed the police that whenever they arrest looters, they must determine whether or not the looter actually needed whatever he had stolen from the gutted, vandalized, firebombed store. So if a wino has stolen a couple of bottles of Hennessy from the Minnehaha liquor store, you have to give him a pass.
Okay, next one. Woman tackles robber. Security footage shows woman tackling half-naked suspect. I just need to say this again. This has to come to an end, this half-naked craziness. If you're going to do something and get on police blotter, go full naked, okay? Because it is a man, we will say it's half-naked. That's how he's ruling. A North Vancouver woman helped take down a half-naked suspected robber before police arrived by tackling him against a wall on Monday.
The question, though, Grace, is were they socially distancing and were they wearing face coverings?
Well, no, she...
Charlie Parker wants to ask me to ask you that question.
Someone yelled out, "Stop him! He robbed me!" And Aaron can't.
Stop him! He's not wearing a mask!
And Aaron Kant hugged him and held on to him and said, "You're not going anywhere." Next up, Arthur Georgopoulos was driving while intoxicated on a road in New Hampshire. According to an affidavit, officers were sent to the Speedway on Hall Street for a report of a Ford Focus backing up to the gas pumps and striking a guardrail. Normally, this wouldn't make the police blotter because it's a pretty standard story, but I just loved all of the details about his glassy eyes and things of that nature. The driver, according to the dispatch, stumbled into the gas station and
stumbled
and seemed impaired. The officers approached him and tried to talk to him, but he was texting on his phone. The officer asked the driver for his license and accused the driver of slurring his words and smelling strongly of an alcoholic beverage, so strong that I could smell it despite the COVID mask that I was wearing, said the cop. The driver, later identified as Georgopoulos, agreed to a field sobriety test and was quickly arrested. During the booking process...
If you agree to a field sobriety test, shouldn't that just be considered prima facie evidence that you're loaded? Because nobody in their right mind would agree to a field sobriety test.
The officer accused him of yelling, swearing, and challenging him to a fight. He had to be restrained. What really would have taken this over the edge is if there was a taser involved, but unfortunately there was not. And before we go, I think I can fit
in. People say there's a Ted's Montana Grill in Westboro. I don't know if it's a couple of people are saying that.
Howie, I think you'll like this one. This is a local story, Somerville. Sleepy drug dealer gets a wake-up call. Somerville police officers were dispatched to the Star Market parking lot last Friday morning on reports of a man passed out behind the wheel in an SUV. Upon arrival, a Star Market employee directed the officers to a vehicle parked in the lot. As the officers approached...
I know that parking lot. I'm going to say this isn't the first time this has happened.
The driver, later identified as Jorge Alves Jr. of Cambridge, appeared to have just woken up and had half-eaten McDonald's food in his hand and on his lap.
I'm going to say that's not the first time that's happened either.
Whenever you fall asleep with food in your hand, that's a giveaway.
You know what's even worse, though, Grace, is when you fall asleep when you're getting the takeout food.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. Also, it says, as officers were speaking to Alves Jr., they noticed multiple light brown baggies in plain view in the center console, along with aluminum foil.
There's another good police word. Plain view.
Rolled up dollar
bills.
Glassy-eyed
plain view.
And what appeared to be a large sum of cash sticking out of a small backpack in the front seat. They asked him if they should know anything about what's going on in his car, and he reportedly mumbled something about Brown being in the car and that it belonged to his friends.
Oh, the old, it belongs to my friends.
There were five individual knotted baggies containing a light brown powdery substance packaged into a larger baggie.
And after you ate one of those or ingested it, you would be nodding yourself. All right. We'll be right back with the winners from Police Blotter Facts Friday. I'm Howie Carr.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
If you're thinking of replacing your carpets due to pet stains and odors, you must try Genesis 950 first. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors so they're gone from carpets and padding for good. You can use it in a carpet cleaning machine and it's green, so it's safe for family and pets. It was the go-to cleaner for when Mr. Gooner had an accident as older pugs so often do. Before you purchase new carpeting, you must try Genesis 950. 1 gallon of industrial strength Genesis 950 makes up to 7 gallons of cleaner, and it's not just for pet stains, it's a disinfectant that kills viruses as well. It's also great for kitchens, garages, grease stains, wheels, tires, and more. Save yourself the trouble of going to the store and seeing your favorite cleaner sold out again. You can just order it and have it delivered right to your doorstep. Genesis 950 is made in America. Order a gallon direct at genesis950.com. Enter code Howie to get more than a $10 value in savings, including free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. Go to genesis950.com and enter code Howie.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States, next senator.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday.
I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the thing.
It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920 and not 2020.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy, and I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
Hi, my name is Jane Lucas, and I am from the town of South China, Maine.
This is Al from Merrimack, New Hampshire.
Hey, I'm Angela from Brewster on the Cape, and this is the one and the only Howie Carr Show.
Apparently, there's more Ted's Montana Grills. There's one in South Windsor, Connecticut, right over the line. And it says that it was, I don't know if it still is, but it was initially owned by Ted Turner and somebody else. And now it seems like we looked at the menu and it's mainly bison. I thought they bred the buffalo and the cow because the buffalo meat was not that tender. So you'd breed it to the cow and you get the cow flavor with more of it. Because of
I just
the way
want everyone
buffalo
to know
was built.
That Howie told me this during the break and I said, oh, that's interesting. And he said, that's just what I've heard, just so you know.
I heard that from the people I work with in New York on the Brothers Bulger. Their offices were right next to Ted Turner's big place in Manhattan, and when they were walking out to lunch, they said, "There's Ted Turner's Beefalo restaurant," and then we walked to an Italian place, which was okay with me.
Okay, guys, we got to get to our two winners here. Police Blotter Facts Friday, brought to you by Pantadosi Baking Company. Crazy naked guy arrested. After running away, grabbing his privates, a naked man who was seen running around Sacramento walked into multiple businesses. And here's the part that's interesting. A woman across the street saw it. She said he was a strong young person. She watched him climb over a bar's barricade and briefly sat with a customer who was sitting outside, then tried to climb one of the bars.
I wouldn't climb over anything if I were naked.
Well, you especially wouldn't climb over one of the bar's patio heaters.
Oh, my God.
People on the street started yelling. It put me on edge, she said, because of the way he was acting. What I have to say to that woman is we should probably check with the police if he needed to climb the patio heater, because that will change whether or not, you know, he'll be charged. Florida woman arrested for alleged attack.
Are these winners? Because we're running out of time.
Oh, yeah, this is the winner.
Okay.
And that was also a winner. Florida woman arrested for alleged attack on dad for relentless flatulence.
Haven't we done this one before?
No, this is fresh.
This is a new one?
This is very fresh.
A new domestic disturbance involving flatulence.
Yes. Nicole DeZoy, 40, who lives with her 59-year-old dad in Largo, a city in the Tampa Bay area, raised a stink about his obnoxious emissions. She allegedly punched him in the face numerous times. Responding officers found the victim with a bloodied left eye and scratches all over his neck as a result. The judge ordered her to stay away from her gassy dad. Doiza was arrested for allegedly whacking her sister in the head in the same home, but prosecutors declined to pursue the case.
What did the sister do?
I don't want to know. Might be what they're making for dinner at that house.
We'll be right back. I'm Howie Carr.
Nowadays, seems like companies are running away from their own iconic brand so quickly you'd think they owed them money. Must be they figured that it's easier to improve the name than it is to improve the product. We here at Matthews Brothers have a different philosophy when it comes to our brands. Instead of naming our products for something that sounds grandiose, like the Super Duper Thermal Insul Shield 2.0, We prefer to use names that are actually meaningful to us. For example, the Sanford Hills, named for the youngest of the original founding brothers, Sanford Hills Matthews. A man who was a skilled craftsman as well as a teacher, Sanford Hills had a relentless passion for quality, and he inspired this passion in those with whom he worked. Always the first to arrive and the last to leave, Sanford never took a vacation in the 37 years he worked here, except to attend his only son's graduation from the University of Rochester in 1885. His passion for quality was his legacy and something that remains part of our fabric today. You can see the results of our continued relentless passion for making wicked awesome windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. That's Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
Brace yourself, guys. Here is 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words. That's not the total package, but there are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they are not getting paid Republicans voted no. Wisdom from the kitchen of Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
We all shop online, and now you can do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie. The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13-year-old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, a bunch of Okie doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s, are now calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here are some rapid-fire questions with Taylor Cormier. What would you eat for your last meal on Earth?
I'm fond of old favorites, childhood favorites. I'd go with my mother's beef and bean pie, followed by, for dessert, my grandmother's recipe for oatmeal cookies and a big glass of milk.
Where is your favorite place to vacation?
Home. I like being home. I like my house. I know where everything is. Yeah, I just like being home.
Favorite Frank Sinatra song to listen to?
It's called Without a Song, and it's on the album I Remember Tommy. It's a tribute to Tommy Dorsey, and it's a very swinging remake of the original orchestration.
Favorite Frank Sinatra song to sing?
My favorite one to sing is One for My Baby and One for the Road. It's a very sad song, but it's somebody coming to the realization that this is the way life is, and they've come to terms with it. And I think it's something that everybody can connect to. It's a great equalizer for everybody in the room.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be. Would I be I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
At no time before have voters faced a clearer choice between two parties, two visions, two philosophies, or two agendas.
Let's choose. Choose wisely.
This election will decide whether we save the American dream or whether we allow a socialist agenda to demolish our cherished destiny.
For one chance, just one chance, and tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
And you talked about the national mask mandate. It sounds like that would be one of the first orders of business.
Yeah.
How would you enforce that?
It's really a standard. I mean, nobody's going to be punished. Come on.
Then as of this moment, they're on double secret probation.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
As I slept, looters were ransacking the shop.
Peacefully protesting in the streets.
They shot and killed David in cold blood.
Protests have been mostly peaceful there.
And then live streamed his execution and his last moments on Earth.
Peaceful protesters.
David's grandson was watching the video on Facebook in real time, not realizing he was watching his own grandfather dying on the sidewalk.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Washington has not changed Donald Trump. Donald Trump has changed Washington.
Always remember, they are coming after me because I am fighting for you. That's what's happening.
Trump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
I did a special website-only column on the convention. It's posted at HowieCarrShow.com and HowieCarrShow.com. Check it out. And also at HowieCarrShow.com in the store, we have a new T-shirt that we just put out for the end of the Republican convention, Socialism Sucks. And if you buy the Socialism Sucks T-shirt in whatever size you want for the weekend, the tax-free weekend in Massachusetts, you also get a free copy of What Really Happened, my book about the 2016 campaign. So get your Socialism Sucks T-shirt this weekend, no tax on it, and a free copy autographed of What Really Happened. It's a good deal. Okay. James Earhart is a former elected member of his local school committee, and he was also a candidate for the state Senate a few years back. And he's a lawyer in Worcester, and he wrote a great column today for the Herald. And it's about the flu shot mandate that Charlie Parker ordered. This is the first time in the United States that we've had a mandatory flu shot. And it's an overreach, I think. But James Earhart laid it out, and we wanted to talk to him about this. James, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Hey, Howie, how are you?
Good. I'm glad you wrote about this, because when this was announced, I thought there was going to be a great uproar about this. But people seem kind of beaten down by what's gone on the last few months, and they just kind of turned the other cheek, and it was just another sort of insult, another violation of personal freedom and liberty.
Yeah, well, that's kind of why I wrote that piece. You know, I throw pieces out there, and they get published in the Herald or the Lowell Sun and stuff. But in this particular case, last time you and I talked, by the way, I think you were in Florida, and I was in South Carolina.
You're right.
hiding from our liberty, and then we come up here, yeah. And then there's a flu shot mandate, so we can't get away from this.
Right.
But when I have three kids, one's a high schooler, one's a junior high, and one's in elementary school, and I live in a really pretty conservative area of the state out in Sturbridge. When this mandate came out, I thought it was kind of a joke, like, okay, this is going to be pushed back pretty quickly. And the reaction from neighbors, friends, and colleagues in downtown Worcester was like, well, this can't stand. I mean, we're not anti-flu shot. No one really is.
Right.
My dad gets it. I've gotten it. My kids have gotten the past.
I do, too, every year. Right. I get it. Yeah.
Right. So, but this isn't measles, polio, or tetanus. You know, this is not a vaccination. So I thought it was just kind of almost like testing the waters of power. But it hasn't gone away. And more importantly, there wasn't much pushback, not because people didn't want to. Just what can you do? I mean, time and time again up here in Massachusetts, since this began, there's been a constant whittling down of what seems like, you know, ordinary rights. And the problem with the flu shot mandate is that at least when it came to locking things down, you could make an argument that, well, we do have an unknown pandemic going through. We don't understand the nature of it.
Right.
We all agreed in March we should shut down for a week or two to see what's going on.
Flatten the curve.
But after that, there was no basis for any of it. The flu shot is particularly dangerous for this reason, that there is no scientific data to support the need for it as a mandatory vaccine. And two, Charlie Baker hasn't even attempted to give a reason for it. In my column, I lay out the legislative basis to allow a vaccine. It's, you know, MGL Chapter 111, Section 6, which says that as health requires, you can enforce medical regulations. But polio, measles, we know these diseases, and they mm-hmm. were bad.
Oh, right.
But the flu shot's been around for 40 years. The flu shot's efficacy is between 20% and 60%, and nothing has changed from 10 years ago, from last year to this year, to acquire a flu shot. Now, when I heard it, I was like, well, maybe Charlie means 1 year as a way of watering down the flu in the wintertime. But Mary Lou Sutters, you know, his Secretary of Health and Human Services,
a moon bat. Came out. Yeah, she's a real leftist. Yeah.
Right, you know, she goes, it's permanent. So my thinking was, if this is permanent and it has nothing to do with COVID, what's the thinking here? And to this day, as you and I talk, and my piece came out today, Baker has yet to give any new data, analytics, to explain the flu shot. And what it shows is this, and I had a quote from John Adams at the end of my piece, that when you have emergency powers, and that's what Baker's acting under right now, is emergency powers, the drip, drip, drip of liberty infringement is slow and sure, and people become tired of it, and they don't even see it happen in front of them. We saw it with the golfing. You could go golfing, but you couldn't go on a golf cart or go to the driving range.
Yeah.
You and I could go to Walmart, which is good, but we couldn't go to the small market in our town, and we couldn't go to church. I mean,
right.
In Sturbridge, we have a Walmart, which is great on the edge of town, but we have a small little place called McNuck's. It's been around for decades. You couldn't go in there to buy meat if you go to Walmart. And the problem we all had was, okay, but why can't McNuck's utilize the same...
Right.
And that's the problem.
Getting back to the golf course, when the woman in the golf cart that sells you the beer or the soft drinks, she can still sell you a soft drink, but she can't sell you a beer.
Right.
So what's the difference? You know.
And now we're at a point though where we all know. I had some other pieces in the Herald where I talked about this in the past. We know the disease isn't going to kill me. It's probably not going to kill you.
No,
it's not
going to
hurt my kids. Unless you're 70 years old or older with, you know, comorbidity, it just doesn't kill. It's just not a cold killer. It doesn't take away from those who died, but as I wrote in the past, no one below the age of 20 has yet to die in Massachusetts from COVID. Less than 55 below the age of 50 have died. Nationwide, over 400 kids have died of pneumonia and influenza, so it doesn't kill people. But yet, the people who should be protected, the nursing homes, the older folks like my father, there's no mandate for my dad to take a flu shot. There's no mandate that my dad must stay in his house. But yet kids in Springfield, Worcester, Boston are going to be online and remote for months on end. To what end and what point? And so when you hear you talk to people, it's like, when does this end? What is the end game? And what we're facing right now, and the flu shot is very emblematic of it. There is no
end. And here's an interesting thing that you pointed out, too. I'm going to read you one of the lines from your column. The order came as a surprise with no public comment period or blue ribbon commission appointed to review its necessity or effect upon parental rights. And you know what's even more disturbing is there's 200 people in the legislature, and not one of them, either party, pushed back on this.
Right. Now, what I saw, I know that Representative Lombardo had a nice letter he sent to Mary Lou Sutters. And Ryan Fatman, a senator from Sutton, had a nice piece. But the problem is, I mean, they're doing the best they can, but being a minority party as they are in the legislature, Tim Whelan out in Cape Cod, state rep, had a nice letter to Mary Lou Sutters. Letters are good, and I appreciate the effort, but this is a question of pushing back on public policy. DeLeo hasn't come out in favor of this, you know. He's not raising the flag of vaccine, right? He's quiet. Because I think he knows his constituents, even liberals from the north of Boston, they don't like this. Because when you start putting needles in their kids' arms for no good reason, they get mad. But what the Republican Party has right now is an opportunity. Now, we see with Chairman Jim Lyons, he's out there banging the drum on this, and that's good. But if the Republican Party could unite behind this, these are the type of issues that allow a wedge.
But Jim, he's the guy who did this is a Republican.
Right. No, and I get that. Right. That's an irony of it. But at some point, you have to sit back and say, Charlie Baker's a nice guy. You've met him. I've met him. He's a good guy to go golfing with. But unfortunately, he just doesn't really support Republican policies. You can be Republican, but you can't really, follow Republican policies. The Republicans in the legislature have an opportunity to say, we like our governor, but he's failing to lead, and he's leading us down a very dark path. And Democrats in places like Auburn or in Longmeadow or even in Weston Wellesley will hear that message, because now you're not standing for Democrat or Republican ideals. You're standing for the ideals of the family. So these Republican leaders, such as the minority leader of the Senate, of the House.
Jim, don't you think, though, that, he was asked about this? Charlie was asked about this, I think they said, they're going to be, religious or medical exemptions.
Right.
So in other words, then, it's going to be enforced as we see fit. It's another one of these. I mean, these are exactly the kinds of laws that we shouldn't be putting into effect, right?
But you do have those same exceptions for polio and measles vaccines. But this is how we know, and this is what disturbs me most, because you know, I've met Charlie. What is he thinking? What is people thinking? Under the edict, you can homeschool, and you don't have to take the virus, the flu shot. But if you are COVID-19 remote, you still have to take the flu shot. So we have kids in Springfield whose parents are struggling to pay their bills, who are home right now learning online. How a fourth grader learns online, I don't know. But they have to take the flu shot, even though they're not going to step foot in a school building until January. That is the ultimate absurdity of this, the ultimate absurdity. And how do you respond? Which I don't know. As I said, there's two things you can do. There's a lawsuit pending right now, as you know, saying Charlie doesn't have the power to close things down.
I'm not hopeful that's going to prevail, by the way.
But
are you?
Also, well, I think it will, because the law is pretty clear. But the problem is, may you get what you wish for. Charlie may be
the law may be clear. The judges aren't clear.
But if the law passes, guess who's in charge? Local boards of health. So would you rather have local bureaucrats telling you what to do rather than the governor? I just think that the declaration of what emergency is key. I mean, I spent time in South Carolina, 7.5 weeks. You spent a lot of time in Florida.
Yeah.
They didn't shut down.
No, they didn't.
Their hospitalizations, their death rates were all, and they continue to be, lower than Massachusetts ever was.
James, I thought originally that I was comparing this state to calling it the East Germany of New England. I'm beginning to think it's the Albania of New England.
I know you and I are laughing, but this is a dangerous situation.
I agree.
We have a situation with a flu shot. I'll give my kids a flu shot because I'm not opposed to it, but a lot of people just don't want to do it.
I know.
Now either you give your kid the flu shot, or he cannot attend remote.
I know, James. That's why I wanted you on the air. I don't know what we're going to do about this, but I want to at least raise the point. And if you're going to see your state reps, ask them what the hell are you doing? You're still getting paid $100,000 or so a year. What are you doing for these last 6 months? Are you pushing back at all? James Earhart, thanks, and keep on this case. Keep on this.
I will. I'll put some more people. Thank you, Howie.
Okay, I appreciate it. That's James Earhart. He's a lawyer in Worcester, and he's a former candidate and elected official. And he's writing about the mandatory flu shots. First in the country. First in unemployment, first in mandatory flu shots. We're very proud here in the Bay State. I'm Howie Carr.
You're tuned into the Howie Carr Radio Network.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Aviva Trattoria. From their famous chicken parm to their gluten-free menu, Aviva Trattoria has it all with locations in Marlboro, Westford, Wrentham, and Maynard. Stop in today or find them at avivatrattoria.com.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or capegunworks.com.
Recently, I had Global Marble and Granite install new gorgeous marble countertops in my home. Global Marble and Granite has the largest selection of marble, granite, and quartz on Cape Cod. They also serve Nantucket, Martha's Vineyard, and all of New England. People are spending more time in their homes, so now is the best time to upgrade your kitchen or baths. Your home is your biggest investment, and Global Marble and Granite is ready to increase the value. Visit their site and see my kitchen's before and after shots. Go to globalcapecod.com or call 508-771-1001.
Here's 1 minute of getting to know Jared Diglio. What would be your last meal on Earth?
Pizza. Cheese pizza. Just regular cheese pizza.
What drink are you going to have with your pizza?
I gotta go Coke. You gotta go Coke with pizza. It's the perfect combination.
Where's your favorite vacation spot?
I'm a staycation kind of guy. I like just staying in my place. But if I had to go to a destination, I love Italy, especially Rome.
If you could live in any state besides Massachusetts, which one would you choose?
Nevada. Wide open land. People leave you alone. Plus, it's not that far from Vegas or LA.
If you weren't in radio, what profession would you be in?
Gigolo.
Favorite comic book character?
Spider-Man. He's been my favorite since I was a kid. He's the most identifiable of the superheroes. He's just kind of a normal guy who's got a lot of problems, but he's got to overcome it and save the day.
Favorite Star Trek character?
I love TNG, but I got to go with James T. Kirk.
Dogs or cats?
Neither.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's.
Ice cream or cake?
Ice cream.
Sweet or salty?
Sweet.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a two-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
Remember the boy who cried wolf? I call this one the press that cried Hitler.
The president is not only racist, he's a bigot, but he is completely un-American. He is behaving like a fascist.
This is the president once again just thumping his chest and acting like he is the dictator that I think he wants to be. The
president of the United States is a wannabe dictator with authoritarian tendencies.
This is exactly what authoritarians do. This is what strong men do. This is what happens in authoritarian regimes.
We have a president with a strong authoritarian personality.
Like a dictator from another nation.
People that grew up in authoritarian regimes, seeing echoes of that in President Trump. He likes these figures like Vladimir Putin and Kim Jong-un.
This is more the actions of a dictator.
He totally wants to be a dictator. It's so obvious.
Much like Hitler took over the Nazi Party, Trump has taken over the Republican Party.
He went full Hitler.
Trump is as destructive a person in this century as Hitler, Stalin, and Mao were in the last century.
It's simply a Stalinist phrase, for God's sake.
He sounded not like a president of the United States. He actually sounded like Saddam Hussein.
This is Alex from East Bridgewater, Mass.
This is Ann in Saco, Maine.
This is John Zuko from Hampton, Mass. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
Yeah, the SJC is supposed to hear this lawsuit that says that Charlie Parker has overstepped his authority under the law. And he's, he never, even if you accept that he had the power, he didn't have the power for, you know, month after month after month. And I think James Earhart is right that he doesn't have the authority. But I don't read laws anymore when a case like this comes up. I read the judges. And I don't have a lot of faith, to put it mildly, in the Massachusetts judiciary. All right, 844-500-4242. We have an announcement to make here. Joining us is Toby from Cape Gunworks in Hyannis. Toby, you want to make the announcement?
Howie. Yes, I would love to make the announcement. So you got to come on down next Friday the 4th, September 4th, and sign up on our website to meet and listen to Howie broadcast live from Cape Gunworks from 3 to 7 p.m. So it'd be awesome. And we are so happy you're coming down again and doing one of your live broadcasts.
We're very happy
too to have you.
And you know, we've done these before, Toby, but it was before Charlie Parker imposed martial law. So you got to sign up now because we only have a limited number of places available, right, for the show?
Correct. Yeah, there's limited spots every half an hour. So if you want to come down and meet the captain, you got to sign up on our website at capegunworks.com. And we have half hour slots. They're filling up quick. So you want to make sure you get your name in and we'll get you in to, you know, be a part of the show and watch the live broadcast. So
right,
it's going to be awesome. We're really excited about it. Might have some specials, some, unofficial cheap bastard deals. So,
That sounds good. And so, you go, what's the website? Give us the website address if people want to sign up.
It's capegunworks.com if you want to sign up, and then you just follow the link for the Howie Carr Show, and you know, you'll be able to sign up on that.
Excellent. Right, and Grace will be with me, I'm sure, and so we look forward to seeing you. We look forward to seeing everybody. We always love coming down to Cape Gunworks, and it's going to be fun. And this week, this weekend, Toby, it's the tax-free weekend, correct?
Yes, correct. Yes, we're really excited about that. It's always a big weekend here at the store, and we're pretty excited about that. We have a couple of specials. Not like we need to have any, but we're having some anyway, just because we love to and we like to have specials. But you know, stuff is flying off the shelves anyway. But yeah, we're really. You know, it's always a busy weekend on tax-free weekend. And I tell you, I could run a 10% or a 15% off sale, and you get people to take advantage of it. But when it's tax-free, there's just something about screwing the tax man.
Right. Especially this year when he's chasing you around, trying to put you out of business and make you wear a mask and do other kinds of stupid stuff and not letting your kid go to school. There's more reason than ever not to pay the taxes. So that's Absolutely. Great news. What's the ammo supply?
The ammo supply is okay right now, except for 380. I'm out of 380 pretty much, but we, believe it or not, have some 9mm and some 5.56. Those are the most asked questions of caliber, and we have that. We have some shotgun ammo and stuff. We're looking pretty good for the moment, but we've had to, you know, throttle the sale of it and limit people to a few boxes a piece, otherwise it'd all be gone in a couple days. So I want to be fair to everybody.
Okay. That's why that's the question I'm getting on the text line. What's the ammunition situation? So you got some, but you have limits on what they can buy.
Yeah.
But anyway, so next Friday, a week from today, Grace and I will be down at Cape Gunworks for the entire show. And we'll have people, it'll be a revolving door, 30 minutes per person. Sign up now at capegunworks.com, capegunworks.com. Stay busy, Toby. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay.
Looking forward to
Thanks
seeing
so
you
much.
Next weekend. We'll be right back. I'm Howie Carr.
The last few months have been stressful for many, and it's time to do something for yourself. Recently, Grace reminded me of when I had that bad haircut 4 years ago. It was actually more like a buzz cut. Although it wasn't planned, I'm incredibly grateful to DiStefano Hair Restoration. Everyone was able to see that my hair could really grow back. I was annoyed when I couldn't get a haircut because of the shutdown, but I am happy that I at least have hair to cut once more. You can have the hair you've been thinking about for all these years. Dr. Hynes did a great job for me, and he will for you too. To learn more, go to hairman.com. You may have more time on your hands now, so take advantage of it and get the hair you've been wanting for years. People always stop me and say, "It looks so natural." DiStefano Hair Restoration has 5 locations in New England and is open for business. For more information on location openings, go to hairman.com. Get the hair you've always wanted.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touch them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again.
1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift.
So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap. And I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You can take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
Here's 1 minute with Governor
Charlie Parker in Massachusetts.
I'd certainly put myself on that list. I'm a basketball player. I always was.
There's a lot at stake here.
This is not a virus to be trifled with or disrespected.
Respect the virus.
I have a hard time understanding when we're going to be able to play basketball again.
We can start talking about a gradual, careful, data-driven, phased reopening. Don't let a few nice days step on that.
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen? And the reason I read that story is because I'm a basketball player, and I agree.
I was first made aware of the discrepancy on this on the day that the registrar resigned.
The vast majority, and I mean like the vast majority of the people who are part of these protests, are there to make a point and to make it peacefully. That is so obvious, I'm amazed that anybody could say anything other than that. I would love to be able to open everything up tomorrow. That would be an incredibly irresponsible thing to do.
Here are some rapid-fire questions with Taylor Cormier. If you had to live in a state besides Massachusetts, which would you choose?
Montana. No question about it. When is the last time you've heard of anything happening in Montana? The answer is you haven't. It's quiet. Nobody's going to bother you in Montana.
If you weren't a radio guy, what profession would you be in?
My number one dream job is to be an antique dealer. You know, like the American pickers? I would love that job. Going through people's old garbage and junk and trying to find that diamond in the rough, and you're always learning as you go. It's a lot of fun to watch, and I think that's why I go antiquing on the weekends.
What is your favorite color?
Blue.
What's your favorite TV show?
The Honeymooners. Jackie Gleason is the most hilarious person on television ever.
What is your favorite soda?
I'm not a big soda guy. It's got to be a special occasion for me to drink soda, but I'm partial to Dr. Pepper.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. And again, I put up a special column on the website about the convention. My socialism sucks column. Go to it at HowieCarrShow.com. Click. And also, when you're there at HowieCarrShow.com, read my column. Check out the store. We have a new socialism sucks t-shirt. And if you buy it this weekend, you'll get a copy of What Really Happened autographed, my book, Socialism Sucks T-shirt, and What Really Happened autographed, and no sales tax, no sales tax, no sales tax on ammo, no sales tax on Socialism Sucks T-shirt, and a free book with it. So go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on store. You can get that all weekend. The sooner that you get it, the better, though. 844-500-4242. Now, before we got full lines here, people want to talk. The president, Air Force One, has touched down in Manchester, and he's on his way to the rally. He's running a little late, obviously. It was supposed to start at 6 or thereabouts. I think they opened the doors at 3 o'clock. And people are asking, is it going to be on TV? I'm sure they'll cut in and out on the various news channels. But you can always watch it on YouTube. You know, just go to, type in. They have a Republican and Trump campaign channels, but just type in New Hampshire rally tonight, and you'll get it, and it's uninterrupted, and they probably got it's probably the stream is going now. I'm sure about that, so you can watch it.
You know, he should be in a pretty good mood, I would think. I just hope he comes back to the drug testing for Joe Biden. That'll really make their heads explode. Speaking of heads exploding, before we go back to the phone lines, I want to play. This is Don Limon melting down last night. I know he melts down a lot, but it's always amusing. Cut 13.
So there is either a disconnect or cognitive dissonance going on where you have to believe that you made the right choice because you just can't somehow in your mind admit that you made the wrong choice, that this is a bad person, that he is a liar, and so that you overlooked all of those things
right. Because
of what? Maybe you're not digging deep enough in yourself. It's not Donald Trump's issue. It's yours.
Maybe.
It's
but
yours.
One,
not maybe, it is yours, because you made the choice. All you're right, making the choice here, and to go to the polls.
Okay.
And to believe it.
I have heard.
Fredo was trying to step in. That was babbling that was going on there. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve.
Hi, Howie. Yeah, I just heard about your new mandatory vaccine edict there from our bourgeois governor towards us proletariats.
Yes, it's for kids. It's for little kids. But I mean, it's another step down the slippery slope, Steve.
Yeah. Well, you know what the other thing is, Howie? They passed a law in 1983 excluding vaccine manufacturers from all legal and civil liability. And I don't think vaccines are necessarily as safe as they were when I was a kid in the early 60s. Because I've heard some weird stories that I'm kind of like in the middle of researching. Mm-hmm. We all remember the contaminated blood supply during the AIDS virus.
Right, right. No, I know.
I
understand that, and I think it should be up to you as a parent to decide whether your kids are going to get the vaccine. It's just such an overreach, and the fact is, as James Earhart pointed out in his column, the fact that there were no public hearings, no commission, it was just announced one day. It was just announced, and that was it. And it wasn't for the duration, as they say, of the pandemic, so-called. It's forever. It's forever. And there was virtually no pushback. That was equally disconcerting to me. I mean, what happened? Where were the Minutemen? Where were the Sons of Liberty? Where are any where's the ACLU for that matter? Who's going to step up and tell these people that nobody elected them to do this? This decision was made by people who we don't even know who they are. But I'll tell you one thing we know. They haven't missed a single paycheck. You may have missed a single paycheck. You may have been furloughed. You may have had to suffer a pay cut. You may have had to lay off some of your trusted employees. But nobody who's making these decisions has lost a damn thing. Did you hear, too, that they're thinking about having layoffs at UMass Amherst? You read down into the story, yeah. It's going to, the cuts are going to fall mainly on the janitors and the cafeteria workers. How many janitors and cafeteria workers could they save at Amherst or Lowell or Boston or anywhere, Worcester Medical Center, if they laid off some of the vice chancellors for sustainability and diversity who are making $300,000 a year? That would save probably 7 to 10 janitors or cafeteria workers. 844-500-4242. Thanks for the call, Steve. Robert, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Robert.
Yeah, Howie, you know, when people ask you what they can do to change things, and you say you don't know what we can do, we really need to be stressing this election. People have to vote, you know, get the vote out, and
right,
you got to vote these people out of office.
Right. Well, I thought that just goes without saying, Robert, you know. I mean, I think the earlier callers were talking about civility, and I don't do you know the answer? What would you do to increase civility or people at least not trying to cancel one another, shall we say?
Well, people just have to live, you know, it's common sense almost. I mean, it's this is all ridiculous in my mind, but you know, the biggest thing is, voting these people out of office. I mean, you got to get them out, and, you know, people have to just go out and vote and stop, putting their head in the sand.
I agree, Robert. I always vote. I always vote. I'm not going to be voting on Tuesday because I'm registered in Florida now. I thought about voting, but why not? No, I'm not going to screw around. Thanks for the call, Robert. Someone says that C-SPAN, one of the C-SPAN channels, is covering the Trump rally. So you may not even have to go to YouTube to see it. 844-500-4242. The problem with Fox or one of those channels is they go in and out. You know, I mean, the C-SPAN or the Republican channels or the Republican streams, they just let it run. And it's kind of good that way sometimes. It's better. Nick, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Nick.
How you doing, Howie?
Good.
You know, I look at Kenosha in Wisconsin and I go back to whatever happened to Paul Walker, because the seed of this tragedy or this series of tragedies, what did have happened there, go back to midnight of November 6th, the night of the election, right? Midnight into the 7th, that is, okay? At midnight, Walker had, and he lost, of course, he had 1.28 something million versus Evers, who had approximately the same. Evers was behind by 2,260 votes, right?
Yeah.
After midnight, 46,000 previously uncounted votes were discovered
in Milwaukee, I would think. Yeah, right? Milwaukee, right.
84% of those, i.e. 38,674, went to Evans, and only 7,281 went to Walker. So the turnaround was Walker loses by 24,000 votes. Unbelievable.
Yeah. And you know, and again, yeah, you're right. Obama used to say elections have consequences. In this case, Nick, people are dead in Kenosha. They were Antifa, but they're dead. And, you know, I guess Mark Meadows, the chief of staff, was on the phone with Evers, the governor, the Democrat governor. He said, "Do you want us to federalize the National Guard and get some troops into Kenosha?" And Evers just summarily turned him down. And then that night, all the shooting occurred. And now they have the federal National Guard, the federalized National Guard, patrolling the streets. You're right. Those people would be, if they hadn't done whatever they did in Milwaukee County, Nick, those people might be alive today. They might be looting a liquor store today in Kenosha instead of lying in the morgue. Thanks for the call, Nick. Let's play. This is Kamala Harris. This is the kind of fluffer questions that the Democrats get. Listen to this question. This is on the Today Show this morning, cut 36.
One of the chief criticisms of the Biden-Harris ticket by some is you're radical. You're radical liberal. And then there were some who were saying, oh, they're not liberal enough.
The most important point I think that can be made about the diversity of who we are,
oh, God,
is an embrace for the diversity of who we are. And that's who we are as Democrats.
So it sounds like you're saying you are a radical centrist.
I am saying I am radically in love with my country.
Are you radically in love with Catholics, Kamala, considering that you said basically one of those judicial hearings that the Knights of Columbus were a radical organization? Do you have a litmus test for pro-life judicial nominees, Kamala, since you celebrate diversity so much? Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment. GetRoman.com/Howie. Jared, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Charlie Parker become a Democrat or remain a Republican?
Maybe he should just become a socialist. I don't know. He shouldn't be a Republican, so let him become a Democrat.
80% of the audience says, yes, just become a Democrat.
80%. Okay. 844-500-4242-603. It's my body, Howie. What happened to that with Charlie Parker? Yeah, I know. Yeah, hands off, what is it, hands off my body, hands off my uterus, that's what the women's libbers used to say. And get your government out of my bedroom. I mean, how about get your needle out of my arm if I don't want it?
Did this just happen?
I think it did, yeah. Tomorrow, by the way, is Charlie Parker, the original Charlie Parker's 100th birthday. Happy birthday, Bird. You were great. Much better than your current namesake, that's for sure. TJ, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, TJ.
How you doing, Howie? Great to have you on.
Thanks.
I wonder if you saw this or not, if you caught it. Joe commercial for the Senate seat.
Yeah.
Towards the end of it, he goes, "I'm proud of my family." Now, during the 30-second spot, I saw JFK's picture, Robert's picture, and I noticed the bull of, was it the bull of the Senate, Teddy?
Yes. The lion.
No
of
picture.
The, lion.
Lion, that's what it was.
Yeah.
No picture of him, and no picture, and I believe the father was the congressman?
Yeah, JoJo, yes.
So what happened to those two in the proud of my family pictures?
How about his uncle, Michael, who had the babysitter? You remember him? Or the uncle of David, who died of the drug overdose in Palm Beach?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, they're How about Joe, his great grandfather, who was a rabid anti-Semite who admired Adolf Hitler in the run up to World War II?
Oh, which selective.
And Joe also lobotomized his daughter Rosemary.
Yeah.
Were there any pictures of Rosemary in the ad?
Oh no, not at all.
Funny about that, huh, TJ? Thanks for the call. I'm Howie Carr.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Radio Network.
Hey guys, you all know we sold out of the Fresh Rest bedding sheets during the Cheap Aster deal, but I have great news. Fresh Rest bedding is selling all sheets at 40% off now through September while supplies last. Go to freshrestbedding.com. For all orders over $50, you can also get free shipping. Fresh Rest bedding controls dust mites and pet dander. This special weave controls odors and you don't need to wash them every week. Order yours today at freshrestbedding.com and enjoy a good night's sleep.
Do you have no water, poor water quality, or low pressure? This is Howie Carr. Call the local water service experts, Skillings and Sons. They're ready with 24-hour service with no extra charge for after-hours calls. And a fleet of trucks stocked with parts to make sure you're not without water. With over 50 years of experience, they take pride in having a family of employees that are the best in the business. For all things water, Skillings and Sons is there for you. Skillingsandsons.com.
Here's 1 minute of Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
There's a lot of restaurants that are feeling the pain of racism, where people are literally not patroning Chinese restaurants. They're not patroning Asian restaurants because of just straight up racism around the coronavirus. So,
you know, only in America does the president, when the president tweets about liberation, does he mean go back to work? When we, you know, have this discussion about going back or reopening, I think a lot of people should just say no. We're not going back to that.
One of the, I know it sounds banal. Do we know how long puppies are allowed to stay with their mothers after a dog has given birth?
I don't.
8 weeks. Wow. So the market has decided that women and people who give birth deserve less time with their children than a dog.
So the whole premise of the Green New Deal is that we're screwed.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
Normally, we give Fredo Cuomo a lot of attention, but lately, it's Governor Andrew Cuomo who's been grabbing headlines. Let's take a listen to some of his best moments.
You're an essential worker, so go take a job as an essential worker.
But the people aren't hiring because of...
No, there are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker. So now you can go to work, and you can be an essential worker, and you're not going to kill anyone.
The number is down because we brought the number down. God did not do that. Fate did not do that. Destiny did not do that.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
Because I can all see you are in masterful shape, buff even.
It has a very nice floral bouquet. A little I detected lilac, hydrangea, tulips. What does it smell like to you? Tulips, yes. Floral bouquet.
Because if that's who they are, and if they are the extreme conservatives, they have no place in the state of New York.
This is Val from Longmeadow, Mass.
Hi, this is Tony and Pietra from Haverhill, Massachusetts.
This is Mernie in Fairfax County, Virginia, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Happy 100th birthday, Bird. Charlie Parker. Heroin takes a solo. Very talented guy, though. 844-500-4242. You want to talk about snowflakes? There's this woman named Abby Phillip. I don't know who the hell she is. Never heard of her. But she's a pundit or something on one of the left-wing cable newscasts. Listen to this. She's having a meltdown over the fact that the acceptance speech was at the White House. I think President Roosevelt made his acceptance speech at the White House in 1944. But he was a Democrat, even though he did intern all the Japanese and he put a Klansman on the Supreme Court by the name of Hugo Black. He had the D in back of his name, so that made it everything okay. Cut one.
This is the president putting on a big show for the country in a way that a lot of people will say, and we should acknowledge, is unethical, the use of the White House in this way for a completely
unethical.
Political event.
Unethical.
I don't know that we'll ever, as Jake likes to say, I don't know that we'll ever come back from this.
I don't know that we'll ever come back from this. This could be bigger than a nuclear attack, than the asteroid that's going to come by on election eve hitting the Earth. This could be the end of civilization as we know it. 844-500-4242. Mary, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Mary.
Oh, hi, Howie.
Hi.
Thanks for taking my call, but I work for the Commonwealth in the group homes, and since March, we've all been in the trenches, and April, they declared a state of emergency, and we started getting hazard pay.
Yeah.
At the end of May, it stopped, the hazard pay,
mm-hmm.
but we all continue working, and then all of a sudden now, we're going to be mandated every 2 weeks to get a COVID test.
Do you have to pay for it?
No, we don't have to pay for it.
Yeah.
At first we thought we had to, but I don't even understand where this is coming from. We've been here for months and months and months working with this.
I had to take it one. I took a COVID test before I saw Vice President Pence on Nantucket about a month and a half ago. And I didn't understand it. Hey, Mary, you know, they give you the test and they say, okay, you came back negative. You're okay. So, but 1 second later, you could be infected, right? So what does it matter?
Exactly. And then why are they, and according to HIPAA, how can we're supposed to be so careful about not giving other people's information. So it's, and then according to the paperwork, it's like a tracking of everything. And
yeah.
I don't think that's fair.
No, all of this is ridiculous. UMass is shut down. They, as of last week, they had done 3,500 tests and only four people had tested positive out of 3,500. That's faculty and staff and students. And the place is shut down. It makes, none of this makes any sense. Thanks for the call, Mary. All right, I guess he's here in New Hampshire again. Go to my website and pick up your Socialism Sucks t-shirt. It's our new t-shirt, and this is the tax-free weekend, and with Socialism Sucks, you get a copy of What Really Happened autographed. It's HowieCarrShow.com. Click on store. Let's hear the president for a moment.
I said, why aren't they here, sir? We couldn't let them in. Why not? Let's let them in.
Yeah, he's in a better mood tonight. People. He's more freewheeling. This
and
is going to be fun.
A floor. This is for Manchester, because you know about flooring. They put in a floor that's like an ice skating rink. So we're going to tiptoe around. How are you, everybody? We love you. We love you.
Damn. Well, you could listen to this somewhere else. I know I'm going to. Have a good weekend, everybody. Tax-free weekend. Load up on ammo and load up on Socialism Sucks t-shirts. I'm Howie Carr.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours, too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and